goes up against the New York Islanders, a severe underdog in this series, led by Ray Ferraro, who's leading all playoff scorers and goals. But they will not have their number one scorer, Pierre Turgeon. For Al Arbour, the joy of victory was suddenly saddened. Islanders take to the ice in Pittsburgh to try and defeat the two-time Stanley Cup champions. And hello, everybody. This is Gary Thorne, and welcome to ABC's continuing coverage of the Stanley Cup playoffs. Round two, game one. The New York Islanders come to town a severe underdog because of what happened in their last game against Washington on Thursday. Pierre Turgeon scores the goal. Hunter finds him. Dale Hunter takes him out. He has gone into a dim yet. How important was this guy to the Islanders? Involved in almost 40% of their goals. Bill Clement joining me here in Pittsburgh today. Bill, they're not going to replace Turgeon, but what do they do to get to Pittsburgh?
Well, Gary, the Islander 30-goal scorers in Thomas, King, and Hogue.
And the guys behind the benches, Al Arbour, second most win rate, but the man on the other side is number one. Welcome back to Pittsburgh, everybody, as we are ready to go with Mario Lemieux out to take the opening faceoff. Pittsburgh beating the New Jersey Devils in five games in their opening series. It took six for the New York Islanders to down the Washington Capitals. Pittsburgh has been waiting around since the first of the week for their next game. Thursday was the last time the Islanders were out. The first game of round two, this one for the Patrick Division Championship, and we're underway. Gary Thorne, Bill Clement, great to have you with us here on ABC. Brad Delgarno dumps it in. Travis Green going after it. Knocked out there with Lemieux. Chased in the corner. Ramsey pinned up by Delgarno. Puck came free to Murphy. Got it out of the zone. Had Lemieux breaking up the boards, as happens so often. See who can get to this one first. Lemieux reaching in. Did. Stevens trying to center it back to it. Lemieux in front. Shot. He got the backhander, but it went wide of Glenn Healy. And the first chance, first game of the series, and of course it's got to be Lemieux. There is Glenn Healy, who will be tested, the 30-year-old, who was 1-1 against the Pittsburgh Penguins during the regular season. There you see his career playoff numbers, 6-7.
Gary's 5'10 and 180 pounds, but logic would tell you that he has to play quite a bit bigger than that in this series. Uwe Krug, number four of the Islanders, lost his footing. I don't know if Mario gave him a little slip with the stick to knock his skates out from under him. It was pretty subtle if he did. And then Lemieux just looked for somebody coming out. He couldn't really dance around himself. But the Islanders are going to have to get terrific mileage from their defensemen. I talked about how young they are. Five of them coming into the playoffs were rookies. Uwe Krupp is a guy that isn't a rookie, nor is the coach behind the New York Islanders bench, Al Arbour. We're talking about two senior guys, Al Arbour and Scotty Bowman. Big difference, though, in this series, Gary. Al Arbour has to do all the coaching, not Scotty Bowman.
Yep, absolutely. He's got to decide how to match up against this Pittsburgh team. Scotty Bowman, 134 playoff wins. Al Arbour's got 118, 1-2. National Hockey League history. Delgarno and Al Samuelson go at it. It'll be sent in on net. Played by Lemieux at center. How often do we see that? Barrasso got it to him. Puck at the save made by Healy. Tom Barrasso at the other end, acting like that extra skater, one of the best stick handlers for goaltenders in the National Hockey League.
That is going to be one of the keys in the series as well. Tom Barrasso, if he handles the puck, will be a factor. So the Islanders have to find ways to play their game, which is dump and chase, but to dump it in without Tom Barrasso getting a stick on it.
And that is tough to do, and Lemieux moving in, and Healy will cover up. The new daddy right there is Mario Lemieux. He and his fiance, the baby was born this past week on Thursday. They haven't decided on a name yet. I asked him whether or not, hey, mom and dad get a little split in division on this. He just smiled. So we're waiting to see what the baby's name is going to be.
There's not a female version of Stanley, is there?
No, I don't think so.
Okay.
No. Young lady, 8 pounds. Pretty good size.
Yeah, 3 ounces.
There's Tom.
Talked about Tom Barrasso's puck handling abilities. The New York Islanders will be hard pressed to keep it away from him. A couple of things they can do. Dump it in soft into the corner so that if he goes to get it, he ends up a long way from his cage. Put it in so hard around the board that he doesn't have time to get it behind the net. Those are a couple of their options.
Shot in on Healy. He knocks it down to the glove, plays it off behind the net. Rich Pilon has it. Pilon moving it up, just underway here in the first period. Dumped in by Thomas. They're going to be looking for Steve Thomas to develop some scoring punch here in this series. With Turgeon out of there, King, Thomas, Ferraro will be counted on. Francis shot it wide. Francis had a great scoring chance. They ended up with a 3-on-2 right there, and that's one of the three things that the Islanders said before the game they can't have happen, and that's those uneven situations going down ice. Mullen trying to get it, could not. We've got the Mullen brothers from Hell's Kitchen, New York, going against one another. Brian and Joey Mullen playing against one another in this game here.
Not the first time. Kind of an old deal for them. When Joey was in Calgary and Brian was in Winnipeg, they played in the playoffs against one another twice.
Ramsey hit behind the net. Puck just sitting there along the boards. Kicked away near side. Nobody could gain possession here. The jam up with King had it. Had the stick on it. Rolled up along the boards. Back to the corner. Islanders trying to hold it in. Uwe Krupp dropped it back. King's got it. King centering pass intercepted by Yager. Yager with Sean McEachran in a two-on-two. Tippett joins the play. Tippett in and a whistle the offside. Yager on the right wing.
Special welcome to David.
And the sticks get up on the near side. The New York Islanders were the only team during the regular season that beat Pittsburgh three times. They ended up, Pittsburgh won the series 4-3, but the Islanders did play them tough, but Lemieux missed two of those games that they won.
I've nodded off over here. Just give me a poke when you want me to talk. Here's Roddy Francis' scoring chance on Glenn Healy. Glenn Healy is a very good positional goaltender. Healy will come out of the net and cut down angles when appropriate. Here he had to stay back in because Francis was cutting towards him. But Glenn Healy, if he gets too far out of his net, is playing against a team that will destroy you with an east-west game. That means if they can get to one faceoff dot, their skill level is high enough, they will look over to the other faceoff dot or anywhere laterally in front of a goalie and really put pressure on the coverage. So if Healy's facing a shooter, he has to have faith that the guy's away from the player being covered by his defense.
Shot and a save by Barrasso on Green, set up by Ferraro. Ferraro dropped it in the corner to Flatley. Flatley, Ferraro, and Green together. Tippett goes down, lost his helmet. Held in near side corner, Benoit Hogue. Hogue dropped it in front, taken away by Yager. And Yager starts it up. Pittsburgh's going to change it up on the fly. Yager moving in. Yager, great skates, tried to drop it in front. You see the Islanders collapsing down low to help Healy out, keep the action away from him in front of that net. Ferraro brings it in, but Ulf Samuelson was there to take it away. Ray Ferraro, 8 goals and 2 assists in the 6 games of the first series against the Washington Capitals. Stanley Cup playoffs in goal scored. Uwe Krupp dropped it across ice, played by Larry Murphy. Murphy hit by Kasparaitis, sent in. Pittsburgh way offside from the Eagle. Pittsburgh, another sellout crowd, no score.
The Penguins aren't going to wait for the Islanders to bring the play to them. Dave Tippett, good defensive player, is going to ride Pat Flatley to the boards on this one, and Flatley raked his helmet off his head. You saw Tippett swipe at Flatley on the way down. The Penguins aren't going to lay back and see what kind of game the Islanders are going to play. They're going to try and take it to them as well.
Yeah, they want to force the play, no question about that. Pilon having trouble getting it out of the zone. Finally just flipped down to the other blue line. Back to get it is Peter Taglianetti. Taglianetti's pass a little wide, have to be played though. Pilon working back on defense here. And they're cleared up by Norton out of the zone. Samuelson's got it. These two teams will do a lot of checking here early on, especially the Islanders. If they're going to shut Pittsburgh down, they've got to be in their jerseys in this game.
The one thing the Penguins know about the New York Islanders, Gary, is that they were a battling team that have even turned into a better battling team. You don't get by a veteran, hardworking Washington Capitals team. Scotty Bowman knows that the work ethic of Al Arbor's New York Islanders is going to be second to none in this series. Scotty also knows he's got a superior skill level. So basically, it works like this. Scotty's guys work hard and don't make mistakes. In other words, shoot themselves in the foot every time they go on the ice. This series should be theirs.
That's what everybody's feeling. Of course, Pittsburgh finished first overall in the league while the Islanders were tied for 12th. The Islanders moved into third place in the Patrick Division for that spot, literally the last day of the regular season. On the far side, sent in wide on Barrasso, who's able to knock it away to the corner. Brian Mullen dumped it in. Near side, loose puck. They start charging. Martin Straka drops it off. Troy Loney sends it in. Loney missed the last 2 games Pittsburgh played in their first round series. A family illness. He had to go home. Happy for him that he is back. Loney in the middle. The shot blocked. And deflects all the way out to the blue line. Played there by Travis Green. Green couldn't control, so can't get it up ice. Pittsburgh trying to keep the heat on. Puck it up on the forecheck. Bill mentioned Pittsburgh's defensive play sometimes gets just overwhelmed by all the offense, but this is an outstanding defensive team.
Especially their ability to get the puck out of the zone, and that move up the boards by Tom Barrasso is the fourth time early in this game that he has handled the puck.
Troy Loney, rebound shot, saved by Healy. Too good, Murphy shot deflected wide. Two strong chances down low, just clear it over the glass and into the seat to take the heat off. Healy, we said he's got to come up big in this game, and here in the first 6 minutes, he has.
Now, Clint Healy has had one of those underrated careers. He has played well in Los Angeles for the New York Islanders, but the last couple of years, the Islanders didn't make it to the playoffs, so you just don't get any notoriety when you're stuck out of the playoffs.
Games coming up later, you see, as the Stanley Cup playoffs continue. Second round for all of them.
Well, Glenn Healy's tucked back in his cage a little bit on this one. Kind of surprised. He's usually a challenger, out a little more. So he may have changed his philosophy on how he's going to play against the Penguins, because we talked about how they'll destroy you if your coverage isn't absolutely airtight away from the play, and sometimes even that isn't enough when the Mew has the puck. So maybe Glenn Healy's going to stay back just a little bit until he feels out his coverage, see if it's there.
Well, he certainly was that time. Larry Murphy back on the touch-up, and that will be the icing call. One of the league's best offensive defensemen right there, Larry Murphy.
Well, when you talk about Tom Barrasso's ability to move the puck out of the zone, you have to put Larry Murphy in that category as the second most dangerous guy for the Pittsburgh Penguins, and the Islanders know that. If Larry Murphy gets into this game and they allow him to be a factor and allow Tom Barrasso to carry the puck, these two guys can use a forechecking game better than anybody, Tom Barrasso and Larry Murphy. So those will be the two guys that the Islanders, number one with Barrasso, keep the puck away from. Number two with Murphy, put a lot of pressure on him. They have to get to him quickly. Once he turns his skates up ice, almost always makes a good play.
Rarely makes the mistake. Shot deflected into the seats as Krupp was able to block that one off Joey Mullen. Mullen intercepting that. That's a turnover. Another one by the Islanders. Second one here in the first period they've gotten away with without having one get by Healy on it.
Ferraro sure did come alive in the playoffs, Gary, as you mentioned, in the series against the Washington Caps. The Islanders were without Ray Ferraro for 40 games, busted up leg this year. He's had a tough time of it on and off in his career with injuries, but when he has been healthy, he's been able to put it together. The Hartford Whalers thought he wouldn't be able to produce offensively anymore, so they sent him to the New York Islanders, and within a season and a half, had a 40-goal year.
He's a tenacious player as well. Barrasso had to knock that one away. Played on the near side by Stevens. Stevens over for Ramsey. Ramsey, he'll send it in wide of Healy. Healy wanted to get it, didn't. Francis knocks it around the other way. Stevens in front, couldn't touch it. Neither could Murphy as the centering pass deflects all the way back to Tom Barrasso.
No, Gary, the other thing about Ray Ferraro is I think the Penguins might try to get on his case a little bit. He takes the heat sometimes. He's such a feisty competitor that he takes the bait. So if anybody's going to overreact and has to work on staying calm, it might be Ray Ferraro for the Islanders.
Maybe. They certainly have got to have him be disciplined in this game. Held in by Kevin Stevens behind the net. Healy will just leave it back there for Norton. Jeff Norton back to get it. 13:48 to go. No score. First period. Shots right now are even at 4-4 for Pittsburgh and the New York Islanders in this first game of the best of seven. Second round for the Patrick Division Championship and the right to move on. Taglianetti's pass intercepted. Dropped for Thomas. Thomas moving in. Thomas stripped by Al Samuelson. Good play. Tippett picks it up. Tippett coming the other way to Yager. Yager. Norton gets in front of him. Yager shot. Save Healy. Rebound right in the slot area. Knockdown. Tippett can't control. Thomas will get it out of the zone. Yager back. Yager dumps it across ice as he got hit that time. Cleared ahead, intended for Yager, comes to McEachran. McEachran reaching in, and a whistle, another offside on the Pittsburgh Penguins. Taking a look at our Budweiser Stanley Cup summary. Pittsburgh eliminating New Jersey to move into this round where the Islanders beat Washington. Turgeon, of course, is out for the series with that separated shoulder. He is here today, however, to be with the Islanders. Lemieux, 5 goals in 5 games for Pitt, and Ray Ferraro leading all goal scorers in the playoffs thus far. 10 points, and 8 of those have been goals. Yamir Yager. Running around in the hallway before today's game. We're going to do a video on him, a home video of what Yager does before each game.
Well, if you can run fast enough, you have to have a steady cam to run by him because he's all over the place. If he isn't climbing stairs, he's running down in the hallway trying to do something to get ready.
He's amazing. What a bundle of energy. Tippett trying to hold it in. Couldn't. Thomas will pick it up. Thomas coming the other way for the Islanders. Greg Parks is with him. Parks, the man who's got a chance. He's the man called up by the Islanders to take the place of Turgeon. Yager the move. Yager dropped it. McEachran shot. Deflected wide. Pilon got a piece of that as it went by the defenseman to block that shot. And it comes all the way into the Pittsburgh zone. Jennings was back to get it. Both teams change it up on the fly. Taglianetti sends it in. Troy Loney along the board. Loney able to hold it in on Delgarno. Played behind the net by Dennis Vasky. Vasky got it up. Samuelson puts the hit on the far side. A whistle behind as the play and the faceoff will stay in the zone. No score.
No, official report yet on Mario Lemieux. However, it is not an equipment problem. Mario Lemieux went to the locker room. He's with the doctors who are looking at him. They just shut the doors to the Penguins locker room. He was wearing a heating pad on his back before the game, and also may have nothing to do with it. He got no sleep last night with the new baby being home. May have been a fatigue factor also. Gary? Oh,
welcome to being a new daddy. I remember Mario's got that bad back that has bothered him now for the past four or five seasons, the last three in particular. So it does act up at times, and when it does, he comes out of the game. So Lemieux's not in right now. Wide on Barrasso, and the shot taken by right along the line by Tom Fitzgerald. Held in by the New York Islanders, putting heat on Claude Loisel, dumped it to the near side. So we'll keep an eye out. Mario Lemieux bring you up to date on his status with L down there at the locker room level. Martin Straka clears across ice. No score yet in this one. Tended for Troy Deloney. Rolls in. Big Troop going back to get it. Healy held it up. Troop went down. Loney set it.
It's the second time Gary Krupp has gone back. Now, the first time was speculated that Mario Lemieux might have tripped him up, but Krupp simply loses his footing. I don't know if there was something on the ice. Skaters can lose an edge, but this is the kid line with Mike Needham scoring the goal. Martin Straka, the rookie out there, with the veteran Troy Loney. This is the line if they score, is a huge bonus to the Pittsburgh Penguins. But the one thing, the obvious, obviously the New York Islanders cannot afford unforced errors. Now, it's tough to blame a player for falling. I mean, Uwe Krupp just didn't stumble there. Something happened to his skate, or he stepped on something on the ice, and give the Penguins credit for being there quickly. If they didn't have good forechecking pressure coming, Krupp may have been able to get back up and get the puck, but the Penguins had pressure.
1-0 lead as the rookie Mike Needham gets his first of this season and his second ever career playoff goal. We should mention, Bill, that the University of Pittsburgh had graduation ceremonies here yesterday. The ice was covered, and they were worried about the condition of the ice. That may have something to do with the players going down here. Pocket dumps it around the net. It's a very warm building as well today, with temperatures in the mid-80s outside, and they never really got the building cooled down the way they'd like to have had it for today's game.
It'll be so unusual, though, in the first half of the first period. I can see that late in a hockey game before. I don't know, but Krupp obviously had a problem there. I don't know what it was.
Murphy could not get it out. Tom Barrasso holding it up behind the net. So a 1-0 lead as the Penguins up on Mike Needham, the rookie's goal. Boy, they have gotten some help from their young people. Martin Straka has been playing, played in six games now. He's had an assist, but getting a lot of ice time out there. Jeff Daniels picked up two goals against the Devils in that series. He's another one of the rookies playing. Tockett drops it in behind the net. Centering pass in the middle. Tockett tried to get the shot off. Couldn't. And he got knocked down trying to hold it in. Patrick Flatley brings it out. Islanders changing it up. Flatley, Ferraro collide along with Larry Murphy, and they all went down with Murphy. Stevens moving in. Stevens dumps it off. Good defensive play. Pilon on the back check. Benoit Hogue couldn't get it out. Francis able to hold it in. The pressure of Pittsburgh causing turnovers here by the Islanders in this first period. Goal came at 8:19. Mike Needham getting it. Troy Loney picking up on the goal by Needham. Barrasso going behind the net to get it. He whips it up along the near side board. Stepping up with Pilon to hold it in. Good job to Flatley. Flatley without Samuelson on him, and we're going to have a glove hand pass called. Bring the faceoff outside the zone.
Well, if the Islanders are going to get it going, you always look to the people who are your leaders. Pat Flatley is wearing the C for the New York Islanders. He has finally, I say finally, had a healthy season. He played 80 games this year. Injuries over the last five seasons before this year have really hurt Pat Flatley's career. In the five seasons before this year, he has missed 173 hockey games. That's an average of 35 a season. If it's not a knee, it's a shoulder. If it's not a shoulder, it's a wrist. Pat Flatley's had tough luck.
Pittsburgh, the early advantage as far as the shots are concerned, but not a lot since we're halfway through the first period. That one's flipped up into the seats and out of play. Second round begins for a number of teams today as the Stanley Cup playoffs roll along. Here at ABC during our first intermission, we'll take you back to John Saunders, who will take a look at how those teams got there and what's going on as far as games being played today.
Sure, Tom Barrasso is aware of the fact that the number two ranked team overall in the regular season, Boston, is gone. Number three, Chicago, history. Number four, Quebec. Well, they're someplace else, too. How about number five, Detroit, last night going down?
See ya.
The sixth ranked team overall, the Montreal Canadiens, are still alive, but the road seems to be getting paved smoother and smoother for the Penguins, except sometimes things seem to go almost too well. I mean, Mario Lemieux is out of this hockey game. We're not sure of the nature of his injury, but I don't know. If I were Scotty Bowman or some of the Penguins, I'd be sitting there going, you know what, this is too easy.
Trying to keep yourself up in these games on the icing on the touch-up by Al Samuelson is not all that easy. I mean, it is the playoffs, and Pittsburgh, as well as any team, is able to motivate themselves. But after a while, all they hear about them is what prohibitive favorites they are to beat everybody and everything in every game. It's tough.
It's tough. I think when you've already won a couple of Stanley Cups and you have good veteran leadership, I mean, and you're looking at a guy that's terrific right now, Ronnie Francis, Peter Tagliavini, who's a 30-year-old defenseman, with older guys, veteran players, Joey Mullen, you've got guys that are able to block all of that stuff out. Let's face it, focus and concentration is what separates the champions to a great degree from the other guys. In the Penguins' case, sure, they've got all the skill levels, but when it comes time to focus, they block all that other stuff out.
They do, and they do it real well. Patrick Flatley lost it to Al Samuelson across ice. Norton to pick it up. Norton for the Islanders. Pittsburgh leading it 1-0. Mullen clears it right back out. Islanders will have to regroup and get back onside. 9:13 left to go here. First period from Pittsburgh. In the corner, Flatley. Flatley tying up Peter Tagliavini to Al Samuelson. Samuelson hit by Ferraro as he went by. Centering pass knocked away. Good play by Francis. Shot deflected deep. That one did not get anywhere near the net as it hit Al Samuelson. Rick Pilon lost it. Samuelson in. Samuelson looking for a little room. Flatley reaching around, poked it away from him. Comes to the corner to Norton. Norton gets it up the boards. Francis moves right in to take it away again. Ron Francis, he's shot. Deflected wide, and Healy did not see that. Healy was screened in front. Francis again. Shot deflected up in the air. Pilon trying to get it. Rolled. Good pressure put on here again by the Pittsburgh Penguins. They keep Jennings in. Left it to the point. Shot deflected to the corner. McEachran trying to center. Bounced it off the defenseman's stick. Cleared up. Shell Samuelson. And it hit the linesman on him. Mullen's got to come back as Pittsburgh hasn't cleared the zone. They do now. McEachran, the rookie, lost it to Thomas. Thomas will bring it. Thomas. Blue line shot. Wide. They haven't gotten the shots on Barrasso. Goes behind the net for it. Freed up near side. Pressure. Malakhov. His shot. Skips off the stick. Rebound right in the crease. Somehow Barrasso got back as the bounce of the puck came right into the crease after he moved out.
Yeah, the Islanders are going to have to hope for their crazy bounces. They haven't been able to keep the puck away from Barrasso, so even the wide shots, they hope to end up creating some kind of adventure for him.
Well, they had one right there. Malakhov with a cannon scores! Can this guy shoot? Malakhov, the rocket! Barrasso didn't react until the puck was coming out of the net.
Gary, Malakhov, even in the National Hockey League, didn't really discover how dangerous his shot was until a couple of months into the season. This is one of the rookies I was talking about on the blue line. He's 24 years old, 6'2", 207 pounds, and can he rip it? Blew it by Tom Barrasso. Last year in Russia, in his club team in the Elite League, Gary played 40 games, he got one goal. This year he got 14 goals in the National Hockey League, which is as tough a league as there is in the world, because Al Arbor convinced him, hey, you're a shooter, you're not just a passer, and can he ever rip it?
What a shot he's got. Malakhov ties this game up at 1-1. 12:20, the time of the goal. King and Vasky had the assists on it, and the Islanders come back on the blast from the blue line. Jagr trying to dig it out in the corner. Krupp had it. Jagr, Krupp doing battle along the boards. Finally, the Islanders able to get it out. And the New York Islanders, a little life right there as they pick up that goal on their sixth shot of the game. Ramsey going back to get it. Ramsey will have to chase it down behind his own net up to Kevin Stevens. Stevens drops it. Jagr out there now with Strockett and Stevens. Mario Lemieux has not come back to the bench after taking but one shift early on to start it. Stevens centered, knocked away by Healy. Strockett was cutting in the middle. Tipped again, that one by Healy as Jagr came in. Ramsey holds it into the corner. Battle there for it. Kasparaitis couldn't get it. Jagr lost it. Krupp ties him up, and the net came off the moorings. Pittsburgh in the Isles, one apiece. Needham and Malakhov have the goals at one each.
You know, besides having a huge shot, Malakhov, I think next to Paul Coffey, is the most effortless skater in the National Hockey League. A huge stride. And maybe this puck move, you can see it wobbling. Sometimes it will move laterally. It will definitely knuckle and drop when it's got that flutter effect. But sometimes it'll even move left or right. Tom Barrasso, I mean, that was super slow-mo, so it looked nice and slow. The real speed shot, Malakhov really ripped, but it may have moved as well.
Terry Gregson, our referee, moving in there. Randy Mitten and Leon Stickle working the lines with him as they get Stevens and Claude Loisel, a couple of veterans, trying to set separate them. And they're getting the sticks up pretty good over there. Tockett took a whack at Loisel as he moved in again. Now Tockett's going to come in and take the faceoff. Quick draw, won by the Islanders. Game tied at 1-1. Brad Delgarno. Delgarno working with Green. 2-on-3, though. Shot Barrasso to save. And a penalty coming up in our first of the game is going to be an interference call on Pittsburgh.
Yeah, it's going to be to Martin Straka, the rookie. He was coming back and back-checking. I don't know why he hooked his man down. He got beside him, but he didn't look as if he was content just to stay with him and to have him tied up. He started to tug on him, and down he went. Scotty Bowman now has to mix his lineup a little bit. Mario Lemieux is out, so on this last shift, Martin Straka was between Rick Tockett and Kevin Stevens. He needs to replace Mario Lemieux somehow until we find out when he's coming back.
Which he doesn't know, probably any more than we do right now. Alf Samuelson will stay out on the penalty killing unit. First penalty of the game picked up by Straka, the interference call. 13-23, you see the Islanders. The power play has really struggled. Next to last among the playoff teams coming into this game. Pittsburgh, in killing them off, has given up only the 4, and they are ranked 6th in penalty killing during the playoffs.
You have to wonder how the Islanders' power play will do without Pierre Turgeon, but he is not necessarily the quarterback of the power play. He's good down low. He capitalizes on rebounds, but they've got great guys back on the blue line. Malakhov and Tom Kervis when he's in the lineup, Jeff Norton. And there's a guy that can finish it off up front, Derek King. He is one of the 30-goal guys the New York Islanders have in the lineup. 38 goals, Steve Thomas 37. And with Thomas and King, those are the two guys that played on either side of Pierre Turgeon.
Norton will be working back at the point. The leaders of the power play during the regular season. Turgeon at 24, Derek King at 21. Steve Thomas ended up at 12. Those are the double-digit guys on the power play. Pittsburgh, of course, always a danger when they are shorthanded, as they picked up 20 shorthanded goals during the season. Brought in on the near side to be set up. Malakhov pass almost. Good play by Mullen, and Mullen able to clear it out of the zone. Minute 19 left on the power play for the Islanders. Game tied at 1-1 with 5:50 to go here in the first period. Norton runs it in by Mullen. There's it to Barrasso. Leaves it. Alf Samuelson up for Mullen. Got the high stick on it. Deflects into the seats. Faceoff will stay in the zone. We'll continue on ESPN Tuesday night. We'll be right back here for Game 2 as the New York Islanders take on the Pittsburgh Penguins. And then ABC's coverage will continue. Next week, Stanley Cup playoffs. Teams yet to be selected. It'll be 1 o'clock Eastern, 12 Central and Pacific. Division finals will be underway right here on ABC. Full house here in Pittsburgh, maybe 85 degrees outside, but the Pittsburgh fans ever loyal.
Yeah.
And they're on hand for this one again.
It'll still be 85 degrees when this game ends.
That's right, it will.
Inside. They sold out 30 of 41 home games here during the regular season. Not complete sellouts for every game, but you don't find any tickets lying around in the playoffs here. Man, are they ever hard to get, even the first round.
Even the players trying to scrounge up some tickets for family people coming here. King and Tippett on the faceoff. Tippett won it for Pittsburgh. Short-handed, the Pittsburgh Penguins controlling the puck right here. And cleared out of the zone by Tockett. Norton got a little piece of it. Taken behind the net by Krupp in his own end. Uwe Krupp. Krupp will circle. Set it up. 53 seconds remaining on the power play. Boy, he's having some trouble out there on the ice.
You almost find it. You have to think if it was a skate problem, it would have been diagnosed by their equipment guy right now. First thing you check is the edges to see if there's a burr on one of the edges. Maybe it's a bent blade that they can't see that quickly, but skate guys are great. They know I'm just looking at it.
Krupp shot, save, underneath Barrasso's pad. And that's where it stays, and they get the whistle. Boy, you're seeing Greg Parks working the power play, number 24 of the Islanders. What a moment for him. He played in Sweden all season long, 39 games, and then came back over, and with the injury to Turgeon and out for the series, Parks is the man. Greg Parks has been called up to take his ice time, and he's playing on that first line.
Yeah, he's a 26-year-old rookie, so he's got some maturity, and that's going to work in his favor. Here you see the shot, and it was a terrific screen that Tom Barrasso, I think, just went down low with his pads in kind of a butterfly position to guess on. But Gary, it's not Greg Parks' job to replace Pierre Turgeon. Let's face it, I mentioned that 30-plus goal guys in Thomas and Derek King on the wing. So Greg Parks is the guy that's going to try and be a catalyst. Hold, not going to replace Turgeon, but I think above all, he wants to try and continue the production of Derek King and Steve Thomas. That's his job.
If he can do that, my gosh, will he be successful. Al Samuelson on the faceoff. Still 27 seconds left on the power play for the Islanders. Krupp was able to hold it in, and a whistle down in the circle. We're going to have Gregson, I believe, making at least remaining on the power play for the Islanders. They're going to lose Ray Ferraro. Ferraro's looked like holding the stick.
Trying to go anyplace. Well, there's Peter Tagliadini holding a stick, but that's not who's in the penalty box. It's Ray Ferraro, and he held Ron Francis' stick. We couldn't see if Ron was trying to get away from him or not. And Al Arbor knows one thing about the Pittsburgh Penguins, with or without Mario Lemieux on the skilled people they have. Very dangerous, and they can't afford to take penalties unless they're monthlies. A stick hold in the offensive zone doesn't fall into that category.
That's not one of them, and they lose Ray Ferraro, their leading scorer in all of that. Now we're 4-on-4 for another 8 seconds, then the Pittsburgh Penguins are going to get the power play. Nice stick, penalty coming up. Jaromir Jagr got hit in the face with a high stick. Jagr's joining the play. They'll dump it into the zone as soon as the Islanders control here. And Terry Gregson was right there and saw it. Looks like it'll be a 2. Well, a kick instead.
Right.
So it is a 2-man line.
And the Islanders put themselves in a jam when the play went to the other end. First of all, here is the hit by Darius Kasparaitis. You know what? That's not a must hit on Jagr, but Kasparaitis has to make those hits. But watch this. Watch 11 in blue. He folded up on the play to try and even the call out, hoping that Gregson would even the score and perhaps call one against Jagr. Gregson didn't buy it, but by going down to try to draw the penalty, that's how the Penguins ended up outnumbering the Islanders and ending up with their scoring chance in the zone.
The Islanders are trying to let the time run off of the first penalty and just let the puck float around. Jagr's all right. You see him going back. Kasparaitis called for charging at 15:37, and now for a potential minute 22, a two-man advantage. And the Pittsburgh Penguins, they've got the shark signs up here. So here's a big chance in this 1-1 game with 4:23 left to go. A two-man advantage for the Pittsburgh Penguins.
What's with this league? It's seafood. I mean, if it isn't octopus, it's sharks, pens.
Penguins. Not sure that's served in a lot of restaurants, but certainly is served up here at the igloo.
You've got to go really far up north to find it.
All right, two-man advantage for the Pittsburgh Penguins, who are sixth in power play percentage here in the playoffs. The New York Islanders a task in front of them now. Koop moves over on Tocchet. Stevens back up for Francis. Francis and Murphy along the blue line on this two-man advantage, just held in. In order to be offside, that puck's got to come out of the zone, entirely outside the line, and it didn't that time. Mullen back, Murphy. Murphy drops it for Francis. They close in. Murphy, Francis, see how close they're getting. Shot, save made by Healy, and it comes by Mullen on the near side. 47 seconds on the two-man advantage. Game tied at 1. Larry Murphy, one-timer, save! Rebound, save again, Healy! Puck loose, comes to Francis. Murphy shot, hit the post! Rebound deflected into the circle and cleared out of the zone.
Well, Glenn Healy is hurt. I'm not sure that last one hit the post, Gary. It may have hit Healy or the shot before that. He is down and he is hurt. Larry Murphy waded into two consecutive blistering shots, both of which I think hit Healy. I know the first one did. Is he holding his knee? Larry Murphy had all kinds of time. What the Penguins wanted to do finally was simply get the puck on Healy and outnumber the defenders. Take a look. There's only one guy in front of Healy in blue, and there are two Penguins. So he made the first save, and I'm not sure that he was hurt on this one. Sometimes there's a delayed reaction on the pain getting to you, but it usually only takes a couple of seconds. He was able to get up after that, face another one. Oh, that hit him in the arm, didn't it? It hit him somewhere in the bicep or up near the shoulder. From overhead, you can see that the Penguins had him outnumbered.
This is where he gets back up.
Oh, he did a terrific job. I mean, he just scarecrowed. He tried to spread his legs out and put his arms out. Well, gosh.
I'm not sure what it is. The shot clearly caught him on the arm. Whether or not he twisted something else and all the flopping around he was doing to try and find the puck, looks like he's going to stay in.
He's got guts. I'll tell you what, don't worry about Glenn Healy coming out unless he is really badly hurt.
He has started all of the Islanders playoff games this season. Mark Fitzpatrick, the backup goaltender, came on for him in one game, game 5.
There's the save that hurt him. Now it hit him in the left arm, Gary, but he also went down on the split. Well, I can only assume that it was with the hit in the arm.
Whatever it is, Pittsburgh maintains their two-man advantage, and Glenn Healy stays in net for the New York Islanders.
And people say, with all that equipment, they get hurt?
You can't hide that skin, can you? Near side to Mullen. End it for Francis. Francis, and offside as Mullen gets dumped along the blue line, creating the offside. 20 seconds left on the two-man advantage. 3:21 to go here in the first period, a 1-1 game.
Boy, that's a perfect look at it. Right in the crotch of the arm. But you saw the effort that he made. I mean, he played that perfectly. I mean, the only really choice he had is to spread out. That's tough for one man to do, but Glenn Healy spread out as well as any man could.
Now, he had all the Penguins hanging around the top of the crease. 12 seconds left on the two-man advantage. Murphy goes cross ice. Pittsburgh trying to get lined up. Stevens centering pass. Too far for Tockett. Francis has got it. Back for Tockett. One-man advantage. 5-on-4 now. Mullen back for Murphy. Lost it just out of the box. Ray Ferraro. Breakaways onside. Scores! Ray Ferraro just...
Wrong guy to end up giving a breakaway to. Ray Ferraro, the hottest New York Islander in the playoffs. And Gary, I got to tell you, he put a major league move on Tom Barrasso, and now the Penguins are arguing, perhaps they're arguing that it was a two-line pass, because the puck can't cross two lines and get to a player. Here follows the puck over the second line, that's fine, but here it is, jumping over Larry Murphy's stick. Well, that certainly isn't a two-line pass.
I think they are questioning whether he got back on side after he came out.
Watch this move, though. He shows shot. That froze Tom Barrasso. That little move of the hands that let Tom Barrasso think he was going to shoot absolutely froze Barrasso. Larry Murphy was trying to gamble and get a shot away. He had to know Ferraro was coming out. Ferraro knows he's got time. Look at him. He's cradling the puck. Gets it flat first. Now watch what he does. Ooh, I'm going to shoot. No way. Tom Barrasso went for the first move, and Ferraro made a terrific deke to the back end. Give him credit.
His ninth goal of the playoffs, leading all playoff scorers this season in goals. His first shorthanded of the playoff, and the second shorthanded goal the Islanders have had in the playoffs this year. The Islanders take a 2-1 lead on assisted shorthanded at 17:09 for Ray Ferraro.
No, I'm not sure that Larry Murphy did know, now that I think of it. You can almost always hear a goaltender paddling the stick on the ice when the player is coming out of the box to warn his guys in the offensive zone that there's somebody coming up behind. I never heard Tom Barrasso whacking his stick on that one.
I don't, and it took a long time for Ferraro to come out. It ultimately was to his advantage, but Ferraro did not come out of the penalty box as the penalty expired. There was about a two beat because I was watching, wondering why he wasn't on the ice, and he just didn't. And then he ended up coming out and ended up being perfectly timed for the New York Islanders, and the man they have been counting on in this playoff series, and more so now than ever, has come through in the first period.
Caught his jersey on a bolt. Something held him up. Well, some players will delay. I mean, depending on what the score is, what the complexion of the game is, if you think your team is about to turn the puck over, you'll kind of hide in there for a second. I mean, there's nobody with a foot on your rear end kicking you out of the door, so you'd wait in there. In this situation, 1-1 in the first period of this type of game, I don't think that would be Ray Ferraro's style.
I don't think so either. The Isles lead it 2-1. The penalty's all over now, and we're back to full strength. Stolen by Samuelson to Yager. Yager coming. Yager Tippett drops it. McEachran to Yager. Yager in. Yager the shot blocked from behind, and it ends up in the seats. But the New York Islanders, the underdogs, have got a 2-1 lead. Gary Thorne and Bill Clement, great to have you with us. The Islanders, the 2-1 lead on Pittsburgh in the first game of the second round in our Dodge Intermission Report. Kings Canucks, a preview of that series. And the Norris and Adams, a preview of the teams that are surviving and moving on there. Minute 56 left to go here in Pittsburgh. Mario Lemieux is still out in the training room being seen to by doctors. We do not know what happened. Very early on in this game, he left. Said he had the bad back problem acting up on him today, whether that is it or all of it. We'll try and find out, obviously, but no, we
always go by the fact that he just had hot packs on his back. You'd be amazed enough that the course it requires propelling yourself in a prone position, and it puts so much strain on the lower back. So there are tons of guys that do that before games.
Taller you are, the more strain you got, and that's bending over, no matter how long your stick is. Brad Delcarno just dumps it ahead, played by Ramsey. Whatever event, it sure has been an equalizer here in this first period with Mario Lemieux out of there. And of course, Pierre Turgeon gone for the series for the New York Islanders. One of the things that happens in the Stanley Cup playoffs, it is a matter of survival. As well as you play, you've got to have the people you need. And right now, neither of these teams do. El Morgan, he's got an update for us, El.
Gary, it's very unofficial, but somebody who was through the locker room suggested that Mario Lemieux was probably having some pain in that lower back, which has been a chronic problem with him. Again, not official. Says Mario is not in a lot of pain, but it looks like a result of that back injury that he's had through his career.
Well, in this case, Al, that's obviously a good tack for Mario Lemieux to take. If it's not that much pain, get it before it becomes too much pain, because this is game one of the division finals. The Pittsburgh Penguins got these big plans for playing till the 15th of June.
Long way to go as they go after their third consecutive Stanley Cup. The way Krupp sends it in offside again. The faceoff will be back out at center ice. Another thing that's happened in this first period, there's not been a lot of flow in this game, and that's to the Islanders' advantage. Had a lot of whistles, a lot of offsides, a couple of icing calls. The more whistles there are, the less chance for Pittsburgh to get that run-and-gun offense going.
No question. Stopping, starting disrupts the team that really has the better offense. That was a situation that the Detroit Red Wings faced against the Toronto Maple Leafs last night when they were eliminated. Toronto was able to dictate the style of play and the tempo of play, and Detroit didn't like it, and they didn't win.
And they didn't win, that's right. Islanders trying to hold it in the zone. They do. Uwe Krupp, final minute of this first period. Centering pass, Stevens took it away. Tried to get it to Francis. Krupp comes back to get it. The young defense Bill talked about earlier for the Islanders has played very well in this first period. Even though they've had a couple of mistakes, they've gotten to cover. Green hauled down. Penalty coming up. It's going to be on Pittsburgh. Ramsey had to reach in on Travis Green, the rookie, who had a step on him at the blue line. And he spun him around. And the veteran defenseman is going to go. And another power play coming for the Islanders.
You know, it's so difficult to attack the Penguins' blue line with speed, but Travis Green was able to get some speed up and getting around Mike Ramsey, because Mike Ramsey was kind of flat-footed when Travis Green got to the blue line. But it was a good move by Travis Green that forced Mike Ramsey into the hook. You can see Larry Murphy back, and you can see that Ramsey let off his hook. It was too late. Travis Green had already gone down.
Travis Green creating that call on Ramsey, hooking at 19-31. He's a 23rd overall pick. Green is, and played the last couple of seasons for their minor league team in the Capital District from Preston, British Columbia. He's put on a show this year. Malakhov, who's got one of the goals. Norton, the shot deflected wide. Final 20 seconds of this first period. Power play, second one in the game. The New York Islanders, neither team was able to convert on their power play chance, but a shorthanded goal by the Islanders has given them the 2-1 lead as Ray Ferraro and Malakhov picked up their goals. Needham has the goal for Pittsburgh. It came early on. Save Ferraro, and the shot's taken. And a point by Thomas. Thomas gets it back. Thomas to Norton, and that's it. And the New York Islanders making it very clear they are here to play no matter what the experts may say.
And I think Ray Ferraro and the Islanders expected the Penguins to be a little rusty. You know what I think they were, Gary? That contributed to the Islanders' lead. But the Islanders know this as well. That rust wears off in about 20 minutes of hockey. So the second period, look out.
And at the end of one, the Islanders have the 2-1 lead. And we'll be back with our first intermission after this word from our ABC stations.
Underway. Pittsburgh, the Penguins, their favorite. They're looking for their third straight Stanley Cup. But Ray Ferraro steps out of the penalty box and scores this shorthanded goal. And it's the Islanders with a 2-1 lead after one period.
Also talked about the Islanders having to get some offense from their defense. And boy, did they get that. They've got two rookie Russian defensemen on the blue line. One is Darius Kasparaitis. The other one is big Vladimir Malakhov. And with the score 1-0 Pittsburgh after a goal by Mike Needham, Vladimir Malakhov moved cleanly through the neutral zone, took a look at where Tom Barrasso was, then blew a knuckleball absolutely by Tom Barrasso. After that, it was up to the hottest guy in the playoffs to give the New York Islanders a lead. The Pittsburgh Penguins decided to stay in the zone on the power play and get one more scoring chance. It backfired on Larry Murphy. The puck bounced over his stick. Ray Ferraro had absolutely all kinds of time to come in on Tom Barrasso, fake the shot, and then pull to the backhand. We've talked about the ice being bad here, and when Ray Ferraro picked up the puck after it had bounced over Larry Murphy's stick, first thing he had to do was deal with a rolling puck. For Ray Ferraro, he had tons of time. Look at him. First things first, get it down flat, come on in, and the greatest advantage to a deke is disguising it. Ray Ferraro disguised it in the form of a shot. Tom Barrasso went to it, and Ray Ferraro was able to beat him cleanly.
What a playoff series Ray Ferraro is having, his 9th goal thus far this season. And the question, Mario Lemieux, what is the problem, Elmore Gatti?
Gary, I'm Bill. Apparently, Mario Lemieux is done for the afternoon. He has back spasms. The decision was made not to play anymore today. He was not well enough to go out and finish the afternoon. Now, we made a deal out of the fact that he wore a heating pad before the game today. He does this as a matter of course, and his back has been on and off for the past year or two, so the idea that he wouldn't be able to play, you shouldn't think that he wouldn't be able to play the rest of the series. This appears to be more precautionary, just back spasms. Gary?
All right, so Merrill again apparently is not going to be coming back for today's game. Pittsburgh still shorthanded now. Ramsey's hooking call at 19:31 gave the Islanders the power play, and they're on it right now. Centering pass Francis there and is able to clear it out of the zone. Pittsburgh 0 for 2 on the power play. The New York Islanders did not convert on their first power play chance. They've got the second one, which is underway right here, right now, with the Islanders leading it by a score of 2-1. Norton drops it off, sent in around. Barrasso lets it go. Ferraro left it to the point. Larry Murphy moves over, trying to cut it down. Thomas back in the middle. King shot, save, rebound, King! And he clears it back out. Barrasso, good save. Barrasso again covering on the point shot. The Islanders putting some pressure on. Malakhov again with that big booming shot from the right point.
But Gary, they not only have good shots, but they move the puck well. That's one of the reasons why number 23, Malakhov, for the Islanders gets his shot away. If you move to him too quickly, the Islanders rotate the puck around the top of their power play. It's about as well as anybody. That was Derek King with his scoring chance. See Tom Barrasso leaning, trying to look through legs, look around, and that baby was coming right up to his chin. Or super recovery. And that's another thing the Islanders do. They'll try and blast from the blue line and then simply overload in front, try to get a 3-on-2 in front.
Norton the shot, save again by Barrasso as the Islanders put the pressure on this power play with 45 seconds left to go. And you know the Islanders are tasting the opportunity to do something here against Pittsburgh while Mario Lemieux is out for the rest of this game. There's the Lemieux factor. With Lemieux, their record. Without him, you see the winning percentage substantially different, as is the offense and their power play. Not nearly as effective when Lemieux is not in the lineup. All that's going for the Islanders here if they can take advantage of it. With Lemieux up for the rest of this game with back spasms.
I think one of the biggest things, Gary, is that the Islanders can now, even though they don't want to, they can afford a couple of mistakes without having their back broken by a guy like Mario Lemieux. But nobody in this league kills you when you make a mistake quicker than Lemieux.
King had the opportunity. Thomas's pass went underneath him. He got ladled on the boards by Francis. Played back by Malakhov, down to 20 on the Islander power play. Norton drops it off. Islanders still have time. Thomas plays it in. Barrasso this time tries to move it. Ferraro was there up to King. Tockett steps in. Tockett with 8 to go on the power play. Back to Taglianetti around the boards. And they get it out of the zone. And that will do it on the power play. So back to even strength now. The Islanders continue with a 2-1 lead, though. And Benoit Hogue is out. Hogue looking for Ferraro off the boards. Couldn't get it to him. Islanders have to regroup here at center. Taken away by Tippett. Dave Tippett moving in with Stevens, cutting Tippett to Stevens, and he ran it wide of the net. And it'll be the Islanders not clearing the zone. Sagason held it in. Knocked down at center by Norton. He gets checked off the puck by Tockett. Tippett over to Stevens. Tockett, Tippett, and Stevens on this line now with Lemieux out of there. Near side corner, Islanders, Kasparaitis. Just underway, second period here at the Igloo in Pittsburgh. Game one, second round of the playoffs. Kasparaitis, Barrasso put the leg out on that one. Ray Ferraro, he winds up and takes it. That one went wide as he went for the far side post. Kasparaitis chasing down to his own blue line. Pittsburgh wanting to change up. Loisel tried to touch that on the way in, couldn't do it. Larry Murphy back, and that'll be an icing call on the New York Islanders. Taking a look at our Budweiser scoring summary. Lemieux out for the game with the back spasms. Turgeon of the New York Islanders out for the series with that shoulder separation. Islanders, of course, the only team to beat Pittsburgh three times during the regular season. And the Islanders, seeing their penalty killing, they have outscored the Pittsburgh Penguins when the Penguins have had the power play. They've done a better job of it than Pittsburgh has. On our Stanley Cup summary brought to you by Budweiser.
All things undoubtedly that Al Arbor of the New York Islanders tried to motivate his troops, but I think Al Arbor was smart. He didn't look at the overall war that he had to really overcome in facing, and the obstacles he had to overcome in facing the Pittsburgh Penguins. We concentrate on some small things. Let's make sure we don't turn the puck over in the neutral zone. Let's make sure we don't take bad penalties, and let's focus on those. We'll see what the score is like at the end of the hockey game, but let's not go out there with the idea of win, win-win. Let's go out here with the idea of playing our game, and the Islanders have done that.
That is successfully here. Needham scoring for Pittsburgh from Troy Loney at 8:19 of the first. Malakhov tied it at 12:20 from King and Vasky, both even strength goals. And Ray Ferraro's shorthanded goal is ninth of the playoffs from Fitzgerald. And that shorthanded goal gave the Islanders the 2-1 lead they now have.
You know, Al Arbor and Scotty Bowman, the coaches who are opposing one another in this hockey game, go back a long way. And there's really kind of a mutual respect, a mutual admiration one for the other. Al Arbor was a player in St. Louis when Scotty Bowman was coaching the St. Louis Blues. When Scotty Bowman left the St. Louis Blues to move to the Montreal Canadiens organization, he tapped Al Arbor as the coach to replace him.
Very respected coaches. Al Arbor, of course, out for a couple of years, went to the front office of the New York Islanders after coaching them, and four Stanley Cups picked up on those seasons, and now back behind the bench, of course, putting this team back in the playoffs after they have been out for the last 2 years. Over to Yager. Yager with Murphy. Murphy moving in as Straka in the middle. Larry Murphy for Straka and Yager. Yager jammed inside of the net. Still loose. Yager still has it. Yager looking for some help in front. Everybody moving in front of the net. Yager. The heck with this, I'll bring it out myself. Murphy, the shot, save made by Glenn Healy, and a whack taken by Troy Loney out front. Islanders up. Islanders have the 2-1 lead, and the shots on goal, there's not been a lot to separate these two teams throughout the first part of this game. Pittsburgh with the advantage early on in the shots on goal, 14-12 in favor of the Islanders right now. Samuelson, his shot deflected wide. Back to Ulf Samuelson. His shot deflected. Francis back to get it. Ulf Samuelson with it. Again from the point. Again deflected off Francis into the corner. Needham back up. Ulf, third time, tries it. Shot it right into Patrick Flatley. Sean McEachran. McEachran, centering pass. Knocked down by Ray Ferraro. Ferraro trying to clear it out high off the glass. Got it to Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald over to Flatley. His blue line shot wide of Tom Barrasso. Needham on the near side. Mike Needham drops it back. Look out. Didn't see it coming. Flatley moved in on Shel Samuelson. Like, where did he come from? And knocked him down. In the center. Needham back. Using the defenseman as a screen. But Kasperide has blocked the shot. Francis in the corner with Uwe Krupp. Now Ferraro back there. It's up on the dasher. Ferraro kicks it away to Flatley. Flatley looking cross ice has Benoit Hogue. Benoit Hogue. Right finger, index finger on the knuckle. He got slashed by Hatcher and re-injured it at the end of the game the other night against the Capitals in that fight after the Hunter penalty. And he had some trouble holding the stick in practice, so Benoit Hogue, who they'd like to have pick the pace up offensively, maybe hurting a little bit on any attempt to do that right now.
He'll still be good defensively. He's the best skater the Islanders have, but boy, when it comes to offense, you've got to have your hands for a hard shot. You might be able to make a little pass. One of the ways the New York Islanders want to try and keep the puck away from Tom Barrasso is shooting the puck hard around this dasher board, that yellow board that goes around behind the net and all the way around the rink for that matter. When the puck is shot in tight to that dasher board, it seems to accelerate coming out of the corners, and Tom Barrasso doesn't have a chance to get behind the net and get it. But you've really got to have it set up. In other words, it's one thing to shoot it around behind Tom Barrasso. You've got to have a guy coming in on the other side to try to get it. So dumping the puck in isn't a no-brainer.
No.
The way a lot of people assume. You've got to know what you're doing when you're dumping it in.
Off the faceoff, controlled by Mullen. The Islanders trying to line it up. Down on the ice, Pittsburgh Penguin caught by that shot. Samuelson, rebound shot, a save by Barrasso on Travis Green. Travis Green around the net had a great scoring opportunity. Ramsey was down on the ice. He blocked a shot and had trouble getting up. Ow.
And that's only the 40,000th time in his career he's had that look in his face. He's still, to me, one of the top three shot blockers in the NHL. And against the New Jersey Devils, he took so many shots down low to the sides of his pads that he had actual extensions built onto his shin pads to cover the sides of his legs. But I think he got this one up high. It's been a wrestling match in front. And finally, when the shot came, watch him. I mean, he actually went down and turned sideways. He may have had gotten it on the back of the arm or the back of the elbow.
Ryan Mullen. Barrasso looking. Mullen a back. Hand shot and a save made by Barrasso. Right now it's the Islanders who are putting the heat on. Pittsburgh clearing it up over the glass and out of play. Islanders leading 2-1, but Barrasso's having to hold the fort against Islander offensive pressure. And a penalty coming up on Brad Delgarno with the New York Islanders. And Pittsburgh will get a power play, and there's a real break for Pittsburgh. The Islanders had the heat going the other way.
We're talking again about an offensive zone penalty. With or without Mario Lemieux, offensive zone penalties will kill you. The Pittsburgh Penguins can still put Joey Mullen, Rick Tocchet, Kevin Stevens, Jaromir Jagr out on their power play. There it was, shot from behind. So Brad Delgarno is off for tripping, and the Penguins power play gets another crack at it.
Or the Islanders shorthanded unit gets another crack at it.
Yeah,
the way they've been putting up the numbers shorthanded. There you see Pittsburgh during the playoffs and the 0-for-2 they've taken today. For the regular season numbers, Pittsburgh finished up the second best power play in the league with 105 power play goals. The New York Islanders were 16th in killing off penalties during the regular season. Here's a chance. New York Islanders shorthanded, dumped in front, shot, Ferraro score! The New York Islanders, Benoit Hogue. Can you believe, right off the faceoff, a 3-1 lead, their second shorthanded goal of the day?
Well, you called it, and I'll tell you what, Benoit Hogue's knuckle looked pretty good on that one. I mean, if Benoit Hogue, look at him standing all alone in front. And you know the tendency when you're on the power play, well, Brazza didn't have a chance. The tendency on the power play is to forget about the coverage. I mean, it's so easy to lapse into, well, they don't have a chance. It's in our end. We've got five guys here. There's going to be no problem. If you don't have a regular strength mentality, at least on the faceoff, things like that happen.
Surprise, surprise, surprise. Three times over here in Pittsburgh right now. Power play for Pittsburgh, but Benoit Hogue shorthanded goal, his second of the playoffs and his third overall goal of the playoffs, has given the Islanders a 3-1 lead. Hogue had three shorthanded goals all of the regular season. He's already got two here in the playoffs. Mullen gets dumped by Flatley. Krug goes back to get it, and Krug clears it out. Pittsburgh, we mentioned how they scored shorthanded goals. Well, the other side was also true. They gave up 19 shorthanded goals during the regular season. And they've given up two here in the first game of the second round to the New York Islanders. Benoit Hogue getting it from Kasparaitis and Fitzgerald at 5:02. And the Islanders have a 3-1 lead over Pittsburgh.
You know, these Islanders earned their way into the playoffs down the stretch when they had to play decent hockey. Benoit Hogue and the rest of the Islanders went 13-9-1 their last 23 games. That was significant. But besides that, Gary, 10 of those games were within the division. And they went 8-2 within the Patrick division. So you can't really say that the New York Islanders came up short when they had to win. There's only one exception to that. The Ottawa Senators, with their one big road victory. It happened at the Nassau Coliseum when the Islanders really could have used a win at the end of the year.
And the Islanders had to come back and win the final game of the season against New Jersey in order to move into third place instead of fourth and not face Pittsburgh in the first round. Pittsburgh still with a power play here. 47 seconds left on it. Jagr right on goal. Glenn Healy dives out and covers it up. The last three goals in this game have been scored by the New York Islanders, leading it here 3-1. Next Saturday, ABC Sports Team. ABC continues its coverage of the Stanley Cup playoffs. We'll be back with you again next Sunday. ESPN's coverage will continue on Tuesday with the second game of this series here at the Igloo on Tuesday night, and then ABC next Sunday. Right back at you, 1 o'clock Eastern time. Teams to be selected in the division finals. Stevens moving in for Pittsburgh to take the faceoff. One back into the corner. Islanders. Francis on the near side holds it in. Pittsburgh still on the power play. Jaromir Jagr up to the point. 38 seconds left in the advantage. Back to Jagr for Murphy. Drops it wide side. That's Lemieux's point shot right there, but he's not out there, of course. Covered up by Glenn Healy, and he hangs on. Rick Tocchet on that weak side where Mario Lemieux would normally be playing. Got a good shot off, but Healy made the save.
Becomes a strong side as soon as the puck gets over there when Mario's standing there. Rick Tocchet had a little trouble getting this one away. Obviously, the key when the puck gets over there is to get the puck onto the net before the goaltender can get over there, and Rick Tocchet seemed to bobble this one a little bit. Jagr got it through him. See how Tocchet stopped it and then turned? Wasn't so much a bobble, just taking time with the transition. If the puck comes across perfectly, you one time it. You don't even stop it. Just try to rip it to the goal before the goalie gets back. And Tocchet had to stop that one and look like tee it up a little bit.
Tocchet had 20 power play goals during the season. He was second on the team to Kevin Stevens, who had 26, and Mario Lemieux was 16. Tocchet now working in this power play with Lemieux out filling in over there on the so-called weak side. They love to move everybody over, like in basketball, the one side of the ice leaves someone over in the far side circle. That someone usually is Mario Lemieux.
And that's when it is up to the penalty killers to try to avoid leaving a seam or a crack or a passing lane, whatever you want to call it, between their four guys.
Jágr the shot. That one blocked. Jágr comes back to get it. Good block made that time by Francis. Centering pass in front. Jágr trying to run it in. Healy's got it. Hangs on. And it's getting a little nasty down there in front.
Pair of tens going at it. Claude Loisel in blue and Ronnie Francis for the Penguins. Help arrives for Ron Francis in the form of Rick Tocchet. Claude Loisel is a defensive specialist in and out of the lineup for the Islanders, mostly out of the lineup for most of the year. But one thing about Claude Loisel, he'll give you everything he has got, including blocks like this one. Jágr's blast. Loisel looked behind him, didn't know where it was, and the Penguins were able to get it and keep going.
Loisel played in half the games for the New York Islanders during the season, but he was sent down a couple of times and almost looked like he was going to be traded or maybe even let go on the waiver wire at one point, and then all of a sudden here he is playing regularly in the playoffs.
Well, the Islanders near the trading deadline wanted a Loisel-type player, but they wanted a player that could generate just a little more offense than Claude Loisel can generate. Everybody wants a big, tough, two-way center, and if you can get a defensive guy that can put up 15 or 18 goals at center and make a few plays, you've got a real valuable guy. Claude Loisel is a good defensive player, but doesn't really put up many offensive numbers.
4 seconds left on the Pittsburgh power play, and that clear for the Islanders will run that off. So Pittsburgh does not convert on their third power play chance. The Islanders back at full strength, and the Islanders get another shorthanded goal to take the 3-1 lead. With 12:53 left to go in the second period. It is cleared in. Nobody out there to help out, though. Greg Parks dumped it in. Everyone else is heading to the bench. All Samuelson back. Samuelson get it up into the middle. Pittsburgh now is going to find some offense here with Lemieux gone for the game with back spasms, playing only in the opening shift. That's a two-line pass called on the Islanders. Stops the clock before a quiet sellout crowd right now in Pittsburgh.
Work during the Penguin power play. Each time the
Well, the New York Islanders are playing it smart, and they're playing it tight, and they're playing it tough in the neutral zone. Derek King was on one side of Ulf Samuelson, and big Brad Delgarno was on the other. Really impressed, Gary, with the way the Islanders are playing the neutral zone. The Penguins have had no skating room. I mean, they're a finesse team, they're a skilled team, and they're a fast team when they get it rolling, but haven't seen any of those. There's no room in the neutral zone, and that is the zone in which, between the blue lines, you establish all those things.
Well, that's just what the Islanders wanted to do, and they're getting it done in this game. Clear to the near side boards. It's Mullen dropping it off. Sent in by Tippett. Healy lost his stick, but the puck was going wide anyway. Cleared up off the glass. Nobody can get it out. In front, Mullen. Tipped save by Healy, and there goes the net. And a penalty coming up on it. Great save by Healy. A cross-check down low as Mullen was screaming through the middle, and he got cross-checked going through by Dennis Vasky.
Did he ever? But that was after he got his shot away. He was right in front of Glenn Healy. Maybe he was a little too close. Sometimes you get so close, there's no room to shoot by him. But Dave Tippett with a nice move here just to keep the play alive, to move it into Joey Mullen. And Gary, he didn't even try to shoot the first one. He just deflected and then flipped over. But check the cross check. Watch Vasky, number 37, just bury Joey Mullen. Watch the swat by Mullen here, though. Watch this. Crunch. And Gregson didn't see that. I thought that Gregson was going to call both. Here's Joey Mullen's tip. Those tips are great as long as you got a lot of oomph on the shot. In other words, if it's a hard shot and you tip it, boy, it really handcuffs a goalie. So it's a quick decision you got to make. Do I stop it and try to take my own shot, or do I tip it? That time, Dave Tippett shot it, and Joey Mullen decided to tip it. And
he made the save on the tip. Minute 50 now on the power play. Pittsburgh getting their another chance here on the advantage as Vasky goes on the cross check at 7:46. Last three goals, Islanders have them. That one shot by McEachern over everybody's head. Francis in front. Stevens digging. Stevens. Francis shot. Healy again the save. And right now, Glenn Healy is standing on his head. McEachern, the rookie, fakes it. Off for Larry Murphy. Pittsburgh power play. The Islanders are leading 3-1. Players in front of the net down. Tocchet centers. Healy covering up. Rolls free. Shot. Stevens and a whistle as Healy's got it underneath him. Pittsburgh, their players are closer to being in the net than the puck right now.
Look at Darius Kasparaitis. He is looking at Terry Griggs and saying, what do you want from me? What do I have to take before you'll call a penalty? It's usually the defenseman that's cross-checking the offensive guy, but look at Rick Tocchet in front of Glenn Healy, flattened Kasparaitis, and Kasparaitis is holding his back as he's getting up, and really, he took so long to get up that it gave Ron Francis a chance to get by. Remember I talked about in the first period, if you're going to go down, and whether it's a dive or whether you're really hit, you can't assume the call is going to be made. In other words, you've got to get back up as quickly as you can, because if the call doesn't come, you're out of the play.
Kasparaitis, who has certainly been a needle in the side of a lot of hockey players this season for the Islanders, and some of the penalties he's picked up, he may have developed that reputation like Alf Samuelson, and the officials are more inclined to just turn the other way when he's on the receiving.
Maybe. I'll guarantee you there are as many wanted posters up in locker rooms around the National Hockey League for Kasparaitis as there are for Alf Samuelson.
Patrick Flatley able to clear it out. 55 seconds left on this Pittsburgh power play. 11 minutes left to go in the second period. The Islanders leading 3-1, and the vaunted power play of Pittsburgh has not been able to develop anything against the Islanders, and worse than that, the Islanders have scored two shorthanded goals against them. Murphy can't hold it in. Murphy gets the pass back. Clearing the zone, Pittsburgh sent wide by Stevens. Held in, McEachran drops it. Murphy, blue line, centering pass, deflected. Healy gets underneath him, finds it with the glove, and pulls it in. Glenn Healy is playing some magnificent goal right now, having to be very focused because the puck's all over the place in the crease with lots of other bodies in there with it.
And the Penguins are doing what they have to do now. With Mario Lemieux out of the lineup, they lose such a great portion of their finesse game. They've got to become the power forwards that they have the size to become. Kevin Stevens went crashing in there. Ron Francis was in front. See them both in there. There's Kevin Stevens going to the front, and Ron Francis is there. So as long as the Penguins get the puck to the front of the net, they've got a chance with their size, which is really their most underrated asset, to give Glenn Healy a real tough time. Not only seeing the puck, but stopping them and the puck.
Healy finished up 22-22 during the season. 8.89 save percentage and a 3.30 goals against. He shared the goaltending duties with Mark Fitzpatrick. Healy in 47 of the games. Fitzpatrick in 39. Healy getting the job here in the playoffs. Around the net, Kasparaitis got dumped again by Troy Loney. That freed the puck up again. Jaromir Jagr, 20 seconds left on the Pittsburgh power play. Mullen got it, trying to clear it out. Alf Samuelson trying to kick it in. And a whistle. A glove pass called against Alf Samuelson. It says, no, I didn't. I kicked it. But Terry Gregson says, you kicked it after you had knocked it down with your glove and got it on your skate.
Well, I agree with the Penguins.
I thought it was a pretty good play. I think Gregson's saying that Samuelson knocked it down with a glove and then the next person to touch it was Jagr. So that constitutes a hand pass, huh?
Well, I guess, but I think you have to motion them. You have to motion towards the person that's receiving, not just to have it hit the palm of your glove and fall down.
Oh,
plus, all he was saying, all of that soccer training that I had in Sweden now has gone down the drain because you whistled that down.
Scotty Bowman's club down, 3-1 to the Islanders. They've got 14 seconds left on this power play. Alf Samuelson sending it in. Healy, look at that one take a hop, will you? Freed up in the corner. They're running out of time. Krupp back there. Four left on the power play. Straka moves in. Martin Straka, Troy Loney, Jaromir Jagr on the power play unit. Penalty is over. Islanders get their man back. Even strength. Alf Samuelson shoots it in. Loney couldn't get it. That one just bounced. So slow, so soft, that bouncing all over the place. And Healy had trouble with that one. It's more than he would probably on a power shot. Our storyline. Mario Lemieux out of this game. Back spasms. He started the first shift. That was it. Ferraro picking up the shorthanded goal, leading all goal scorers in the playoffs thus far with 9. The Islanders, they're penalty killing. They've outscored Pittsburgh on the power play 4-3 in the regular season, and they've had 2 shorthanded goals today. Those add up in a hurry when you're able to get those kind of goals.
Well, Scotty Bowman made the point to us during the Devils series that the Penguins played about how crucial shorthanded goals are. They're not only goals that you don't expect to have scored against you, but because of that, they end up being deflating goals, especially when they come early in the hockey game, and they came early for the Islanders.
Islanders had 12 during the regular season. Already have picked up 2 in this game and 3 in the playoffs. Even strength now with 9:50 to go here in the second period. Troy Loney battling in the corner. Jager there, Norton tying him up. Troy Loney's got it. Loney hit by Richard Pilon from behind. Jager again has it in the skates, trying to roll it free to Straka. Straka getting pinned up on the boards. Claude Loisel. Loisel and Straka. Jager moves over. Loisel not going to let him go. Back to Loney. Rich Pilon on him. Straka moving to the middle. Jager shot, save made again by Healy. It's a battle to get a shot right now. Brought up by Thomas. Thomas moving in. Tom Barrasso's watched most of this second period while the play has been in the other end. Jager gets it back. King had the intercept at the blue line. King, he'll rag it, waiting for his teammates to get onside. Jager intercepts. Jager's getting a lot of ice time here. Shot deflected in. Healy had to make a save. Kicked in by his own player. Jeff Daniels ended up with a shot. Rebound came back out towards the top of the crease. Centering pass. Yells Samuelson back to get it. Barrasso also helped out on the play. Islanders keeping the heat on. They've been doing that all game. Point shot. Malakhov deflects to the corner. Over to get it. Greg Parks. Parks right back to him. Samuelson moves over on him. Tipped it into King. King, Parks, Thomas on this line for the Islanders. Pucks in the corner. Both teams look like they'll take the faceoff here, and they'll get it with 8:32 left to go in the second, and the Islanders up by 2.
5'10 and 180 pounds, but Glenn Healy has been as big as a car in there for the New York Islanders in this hockey game. Watch this double carom. Shot by Jeff Daniels, hit a couple of sets of legs, and Glenn Healy followed it all the way. It went off Derek King, and then it went off Jager, I guess, in front out of that pile. And Healy, because he had Ronnie Francis barreling in on him, smartly deflected it by the attacker instead of leaving it on the doorstep.
Face off in the Pittsburgh zone. Kasparaitis held it in, at least momentarily. Claude Loisel battling. Taglianetti came away with it. Center right out in front of his own goaltender. Pilon moves up. A Krupp in. Krupp. Backhand shot. Rolls top of the crease. Nobody's got it. It's behind the net. Taglianetti back to get it. Great scoring chance right there for the New York Islanders. And the oohing and awing here going on in Pittsburgh as the fans, a sellout crowd. Surprise that the show the Islanders are putting on. This good, steady play has highlighted their entire season. Krupp having to back up. Stevens up on the forecheck. Get it away to Ferraro. Ferraro sends it in. Tom Barrasso moving back to help out. Shots are 20-19 in favor of Pittsburgh, but it's a 3-1 Islander lead with 2 shorthanded goals on the board. Delgarno intercepts. Moving in the right side, Brad Delgarno centering Travis Green. He got knocked down from behind by Taglianetti. Pittsburgh here at home this season. They only lost 6 games all year. They were 32-6-4. The New York Islanders came away with 2 of those wins against Pittsburgh in their own home ice. The only team to beat them twice in here. Delgarno looking. Delgarno centering. Just backed up. Nobody there but Samuelson. The Islanders are creating the opportunities, though, and Pittsburgh right now not getting them. Stevens brings it up. His shot. Blocker saved by Healy, but a whistle and offside on that before that shot was taken.
Kevin Stevens has to step it up a little bit, Gary. I mean, he didn't have the best series of his life against the New Jersey Devils. A lot of other people played to their potential. Kevin Stevens still has something left, and he'll have to turn it on depending on how serious the Mario Lemieux back injury is. Little traffic? Yeah, a lot of traffic. Tom Barrasso had 4 of his guys collapse back down in front of him to try and protect him.
Stevens had the flu for the last 3 months, an infection they couldn't quite get cured, and really sapped his strength at the end of the year and during the first round of the playoffs. And he's not 100% yet, I don't think. But playing, Stevens shot. He missed it wide. Thomas moves up. Thomas trying to drop it off. Tockett holds it in. Tockett shot. He missed it. Short side. Larry Murphy. Murphy center. Bounces in the air off Stevens to Tockett. Around the boards, Grant Jennings. Jennings able to hold it in. Tockett still tied up behind the net. Couldn't do anything with that. And the Islanders, Norton, able to clear it out. Knocked away by Parks at center. Sent right back up ice. Pilon there. Richard Pilon in the middle for Derek King. King blue line shot. Barrasso to save. He got Murphy spun around and took the shot on him that time. Norton back at his own blue line. Drops it off again for Parks. Greg Parks. Go back to Krupp. Krupp working with Norton. Parks out there. He's got King and Thomas with him. Thomas in. Thomas faked it. Tried to drop it in. Alf Samuelson taking King out on the far side. Glenn Healy. that one rolled as Coop came back to help out. 6 minutes to go, second period. Islanders doing virtually everything they want to do in this game, dictating the style of play, creating chances, not making a lot of mistakes. Samuelson with a hit, freed the puck up. The Islanders held it in again. Kasparaitis gets tied up, goes to the corner court. Jagr comes over. Jaromir Jagr starting it up. Kasparaitis hooking and hacking from behind on him. Jagr bringing it in. Jagr the move. Jagr flashing got enough to knock it away. And Kasparaitis played the puck.
Where the Islanders always have three men back. And when the puck goes into the corner in the Islanders zone, you notice that they've always got an outnumbered situation going.
Ferraro rolled it in. He just couldn't get it on the stick for the shot. Straka in the corner. Comes to the point. Shot there. Save made by Barrasso. And that will be held onto. Dennis Vasky found himself all alone at the point. But Barrasso saw it coming all the way. Want to remind you, we'll continue our coverage of EC.
You know, most of the flow of this hockey game has been created on offense by the New York Islanders. Tom Barrasso has faced so many close-in chances, but the New York Islanders, I think, have had more skating room than the Penguins. Keep in mind, the Pittsburgh Penguins came into the playoffs having finished with the third-best defensive record overall in the National Hockey League, so you shouldn't have much skating room against them. The New York Islanders have had more skating room than the Penguins. The Islanders defensively have been terrific.
Really outplayed him in this game. Knocked down by Malakhov. Taken by Larry Murphy at center. Up for Mullen. 5 minutes to go here in the second. Mullen trying to run it in. Got it back. Down low, Francis centered off Healy's stick. The goaltender had to knock away the centering pass. Murphy winds up. Takes the shot. Tip score! Daniels hit it the first time. And Mullen may have tipped it on the far side. But it's a 3-2 game.
That the New York Islanders haven't covered really well is now and again in front. They've allowed the Penguins to outnumber them and get in behind them. Malakhov laid off Jeff Daniels, and he tipped it perfectly. Remember, we talked about how hard the shot is coming. Do you stop it, shoot it, or do you tip it? Well, this one had a lot on it, so Jeff Daniels, all he had to do was redirect it. And Glenn Healy had to stand there helplessly as it went through his legs. But look what's in behind. See Ron Francis on the top left, number 10. He is actually in behind number 14, Tom Fitzgerald. Daniels was to the side of Malakhov. So man-to-man coverage for the Islanders has to be tighter in front. That's the only area that I've noticed that doesn't. They don't seem to be really on top of their game.
Boy, Jeff Daniels, what a job he's doing as he picks up his third playoff goal. And it is a 3-2 lead now for the Islanders. Rookie Jeff Daniels. The other's been picked up by rookie Mike Needham in this game. Sent into the corner. Going back to get a Taglianetti, and that'll be touched up for the icing call. And the Pittsburgh Penguins have battled back. Gary Thorne and Bill Clement and Jeff Daniels, the rookie, who has picked up at 15-10 his third goal to the playoffs. Larry Murphy, the assist, and Pittsburgh back to within one.
Scotty Bowman likes Jeff Daniels. He likes the way he plays. He's kind of a small Bob Gainey of style. Doesn't hit as much as Gainey, but he's sound defensively. As long as you can skate and play sound defense, you've always got a chance to get on the ice when Scotty Bowman's coaching.
That has fired up the Pittsburgh Penguins. Tockett taking Norton down. Tockett digging in the corner. Norton gets up, pulled away by Tockett, comes right back for it. Great battle right there. Held in by Al Samuelson for Tockett. You can see the fire. Ooh, Delgado just took a shot at Samuelson. No call on it. Two on two the other way. Proof. I mean, that was a right-hander. Just wound up and let him have it. Knocked his helmet off. Al Samuelson along the blue line. Stays out there without the helmet now.
Thought his head was in the helmet for a minute.
Wow, did he get him. Pittsburgh trying to get this game tied up. Stevens trying to center. Taken out of the play by Norton on the far side. Mullen brought down by Stevens. Everybody hanging on now. Wind up. No shot. Tried to dump it in front. Tockett played a little too long with that one. And Gary Gregson, the referee, letting some of the hooking and slashing go on right now.
But Gary, he's letting a lot go. He just let a trip really by Kevin Stevens go, and he let another one go. I mean, he's let a lot of that go. So at what point does he change his style? I mean, if he can't go on, then one team claims that there's been an injustice committed. I mean, you've got to go one way or the other and be consistent. It'll be interesting to see which way Terry Gregson goes with this.
New York Islanders coming back to put the heat on. Jennings puts the hit on the far side on Travis Green. Puck free to the near corner. Thomas sends it back for Green. Jennings steps up. Sean McEachran will play it. 3 minutes to go, second period. Islanders up by one from the blue line. McEachran tied up by Malakhov. Yager. Yager really got nailed by Dennis Vasky that time. Near side Samuelson. Shell Samuelson had it blocked. Shot it right into Derek King. Cleared around by Needham to Yager. Yager trying to run it on net with the defenseman between he and the goaltender. And Glenn Healy comes up, covers it up. Pittsburgh fans, like their team, are back into this one.
Boy, even with skating room in the neutral zone for Sean McEachran, who's a top skater, with Jaromir Jagr going with them, there's just no room when they get to the blue line. Here comes Sean McEachran across his own blue line. Now he's looking. He's going to end up faking a shot. But you can see number 32, Thomas, back. There's Malakhov. There are actually two other Islanders back to make a total of four. And you can see McEachran was driven to the side. The Islanders have men back on every rush. It's those odd man advantages, the breakaways, the two-on-ones, and the three-on-twos that will kill you. The Islanders know that, and they know they can't give the Penguins any. So you take those away from the Penguins, and you take away the finesse. You force the Penguins to be kind of a dump-and-chase team. They're not that.
That's not their style. Not their style at all. You joined us late. Mario Lemieux out, took only the opening shift. Back spasms. He's out for the remainder of the day. Pierre Turgeon, of course, missing for the New York Islanders, their leading scorer. Shoulder separated on the hit by Hunter in the last game they played on Thursday against the Washington Capitals. He is here, however, and he's going to be joining us during the second intermission. Al will be talking with him. Ferraro brings it out. Ray Ferraro picked up his ninth goal of the playoffs for the New York Islanders here today. Jennings back to get it. Wound it up along the board. Daniels got it out to center. Islanders Malakhov was right there to play it. They go back into their own end as they regroup with 2:25 to go. At center, played by Benoit Hogue. Hogue winds up and takes it. Save. Barrasso get it with a stick. Malakhov a little room. Malakhov shot deflected in front. Taken by Ferraro. Ferraro dropped it. Malakhov centering it. Right through everybody to the near side board. Pushed up along the boards. And the Islanders want a penalty called right there, because without a stick, Francis decided to just smother it against the boards. Could be a delay of game, but won't be. Coming up during our second intermission of the Islander Penguins game. This, of course, the first game of the second round. We'll have second period analysis. The profile on the money goaltender Tom Barrasso and Pierre Turgeon, live and in person from the Igloo here in Pittsburgh. 2:06 left to go in it. Al Arbor's team, if there's one thing you can be sure of, the tenacity and grit style you see will last the entire 60 minutes. It won't stop.
That's the way Al played. They asked Scotty Bowman to really characterize Al Arbor as a hockey player, because Bowman coached Arbor in St. Louis. He said he was a great team guy. He played very hard. In every game he was intense and came to play. And that's the kind of play that he demands from his players. I mean, you can't be the kind of player that takes a free ride out there every second shift and play for Al Arbor.
You just don't play at that start. Glenn Healy out to get it as Troy Loney was moving in. Jams back into the circle. Ray Ferraro clears it wide side. A minute 49 to go here in the second period. Knocked away by Troy Loney. Martin Straka's got Yager with him. 3-on-2 break. Straka. Yager. You saw it. Yager behind the net. But Troy Loney can't get anybody with it. Bounces away to center.
Well, the other thing about Al Arbor, Gary, when he played with glasses. He actually wore glasses during his entire career and still is one of the greatest shot blockers who have ever played the game, and he did it with glasses on.
There aren't many who have ever done that at any level in hockey. Norton going back to get it. Great chance for Pittsburgh. They lost it on that last break. Ended up with a 3-on-2 chance and never got a shot on goal. Alf Samuelson sends it in wide. Healy tipped it away. A minute 10 to go in the period. Up to the point. Ends up on the Pittsburgh bench getting the whistle. Shots are 22-21 in favor of the Islanders, who are hanging on to that 3-2 lead.
Well, you have to go back to 1970 when Al Arbor took over from Scotty Bowman, and this is the way those men looked in 1970. The glasses Al wore when he played. Those are the nice black horn rim ones that he used when he was behind the bench. They actually look more like the glasses he's got on right now, the ones that he wore back then. They had lighter rims and they were rounder than that.
They probably didn't have those plastic lenses then either. Probably was real glass. 1:07 remaining here. Mike Needham started the scoring in the first. Then Malakhov, Ferraro, and Benoit Hogue. Three unanswered goals to the Islanders. Jeff Daniels has picked one up at 15:10 of this third period to make it a 3-2 lead for the Islanders. Weird around. Del Garno, what a shot. shot on Samuelson, who lost his helmet again. Green brings it up. Travis Green shot. Save Barrasso. Has to drop it off, and off Samuelson for the second time in the period without his helmet out there. He got nailed at the blue line. Stevens drops it off. Shel Samuelson comes back to get it. He sends it in behind the net, held up by Healy. Taken by Norton. Norton around the boards. There's Del Garno again over there with Samuelson. Samuelson, he rocked, or thought he was going to rock Del Garno. Instead, the rocking went the other way on that check. Near side attended for Francis. Great poke check by Malakhov. Just reached in and knocked it away. Mullen brings it up to the Islanders. Mullen kicking it back on. Brian Mullen dumps it behind the net. 20 seconds left here in the second period. Samuelson. Pittsburgh not used to going to the dressing room trailing much of this season. That just didn't happen. Back up on the far side. Under 9 to go. One more chance here for the New York Islanders. Benoit Hogue brings it in. Hogue looking to the middle for Flatley. He fell down. Samuelson the puck up for Mullen, and that's going to do it. The Islanders have got a 3-2 lead after two.
Boy, they are where they want to be, and Benoit Hogue's knuckle doesn't look that bad at all. He took two super shots in the second period. Big question for me and the Islanders in the third period. What are they going to do style-wise? Are they going to collapse and sit on the lead, or are they going to try and widen it? We'll have to wait and see.
And the Pittsburgh Penguins, who have not lost in the last 9 playoff games here at home, are trailing. We'll be back, second intermission, after this word from our ABC stations. New York Islanders with the 3-2 lead at the end of two periods, and as we said, they are doing this without their leading scorer, Pierre Turgeon. He took that vicious shot at the end of the last game against the Washington Capitals when, after Turgeon had scored the goal on Thursday, Dale Hunter came across ice on him. Right here. Separated shoulder. Hunter, of course, has been indefinitely suspended. The league has not yet decided what they're going to do about Hunter. Turgeon's just waiting to play, and Elmore Gandy is with him. Al?
Pierre, first of all, how is the shoulder? How does it feel? I know you had therapy this morning. Is it coming along okay?
Yeah, I feel pretty good right now, but still, you know, a little bit sore, and I can't really do some quick movement. I gotta go really slow, and last few days I've been doing therapy, and hopefully it's gonna be better in the next week or so, and we'll see from there.
Originally we thought 6 weeks, and in the playoffs a lot of times the guys get healthier quicker than they should, I guess you could say. Is there any chance you come back in this series winning the first game if it goes long enough?
Well, that'll be tough, but you never know. You know, we're working hard right now to do some movement on the shoulder, and like I said, we'll see. We're taking day by day and see from there. Right now, we can't really tell when I'm gonna get back.
Okay, you came in today from New York to be around the club. Can you still be a factor with the team, a leader in the locker room, in spite of the injury?
Oh yeah, I mean, I just I want to try to follow the team and to be here. I think I went to the dressing room before and talk a little bit to the guys, and the guys want to do well without me in the lineup, and I think they will. And like I said, I want to be around the guys, and if, like you said, I want to be a factor to them if they can win.
How about the first game, getting a jump like this, your team? How important is that to them?
It's a big, we've been playing very well lately, and especially that game, and we're playing pretty good, and Ferraro has been doing very well, and that first game is very important for us. We want to get that to that first game and see from there. But we'll see, interpret what's going to happen.
Okay, what has to happen in this last period for the Islanders to come out with a win in this game?
Well, I think we're going to have to step up and play very well defensively and don't give too many 3-on-2 or 2-on-1, because we know the Penguins got a lot of talent and they can score a lot of goals, so we just have to be aware of that. And Glenn Healy is going to have to come out really strong, like he did the first and second period. And he's going to do the same thing, so everything's going to work out well.
Pierre, good luck, and hope you're back soon. Gary?
And for the New York Islanders, they hope they'll go on long enough so that he'll have a chance to come back and play, but it won't be in this series against Pittsburgh. But the Islanders, after two, are leading the Pittsburgh Penguins by a score of 3-2. Only 16 times during the regular season, Pittsburgh trail going to the third. And And welcome back, everybody, to Pittsburgh, where the New York Islanders are leading Pittsburgh by a score of 3-2. Gary Thorne and Bill Clement, the surprise is on right now. As we said, Pittsburgh 16 times, that's all, during the regular season. Did they go into the third trailing? The Islanders have an upset in mind.
You know one thing, when you play the Pittsburgh Penguins, I don't care who you are, you've got to get solid goaltending. The Islanders got that from Glenn Healy so far in this hockey game. And a guy with a broken knuckle, Benoit Hogue, gave the Islanders their second shorthanded goal of the game. And a 3-1 lead on a real nice feed, but let's face it, poor coverage by the Pittsburgh Penguins. So at that point in the second period, 3-1 for the New York Islanders. But Larry Murphy, all the New York Islanders do. When you get the puck back in your defensive zone and you're trying to preserve a lead, the natural thing is just to try to get the puck out of the zone. What happens then? The team regroups that you've dumped it to, and they come right back at you. So the Islanders are going to have to take a look, perhaps make a play out of their zone, and generate some offense. If the Islanders play in their own zone this entire third period, it'll be a long third period for them.
Jammed up, Travis Green, and taken away by Francis, cleared up to Mullen. Back to Kasparaitis, save made for Barrasso. You see Barrasso's going to try and help get it out of there. Stevens over to Francis. Francis in onside. Takes the shot. Healy, the save off the shoulder. Good, quick shot. Pittsburgh's going to start right out here trying to pump that offense up and put some heat on Healy and the New York Islanders. Going back on the touch-up, Larry Murphy, and that will be an early icing for the New York Islanders. Pittsburgh having won 4 out of 5 against New Jersey, coming in here in the first game of the second round of the Stanley Cup playoffs. See what they have done when they trailed after 2, regular season and in the playoffs.
The difference in this situation is those 2 comeback victories were against the New Jersey Devils with Mario Lemieux in the lineup. He left this lineup in the first period and has not returned with back spasms. So guys like Rick Tocchet and even the rookie that you saw a moment ago, Martin Straka, number 82, who is going to be out there between Sean McEachern and Rick Tocchet, have to provide the offense. Scotty Bowman hasn't seemed to really have gone with a pat set of lines since Mario left this hockey game, Gary. He's really mixed and matched rookies with veterans, sometimes all veterans. At one time, he had the rookies out there together.
Trying to find some hot sticks here. Tocchet in front, couldn't get it lined up for the shot. Taken out by King against the boards, gets pinned up there, or rather was pinned up by Baskey. Cleared on the near side there. Flatley, who got it out to center. And it's Ferraro who sends it in. The Islanders will try and catch Pittsburgh, sending their people in the offensive end. It breaks the other way. Ferraro dumped it out. McEachern wheels around, sends it back near side. Taglianetti. Taglianetti off the board. Straka giving chase. Healy got there first. Malakhov moves over. Up, not out. Samuelson the shot. Healy the save and kicks that one about 40 rows back into the seats. He'll do a lot of that. He'll do everything he can to stop the game here. I would think, Bill, this third period, just to slow this thing down.
Absolutely. Chop it up all he can. I don't think he wants to try necessarily for faceoffs in his zone, but if it's the difference between stopping the play and letting really a hot attack continue, Healy has to get it over the glass on a deflection like that. Of course, if he shoots it over the glass and it doesn't touch anything on the way over, it's a penalty.
As long as he's making the save, he can get away with it. Third period just underway here at the Igloo in Pittsburgh. Fitzgerald has had a couple of assists in this game. Moving in to take the faceoff against Martin Straka. Straka lost it. Good play by Fitzgerald to win it. Near side is Krupp. Krupp drops it back to him. And the Islanders right back up. They're going to get it in a hurry. Sent in by Fitzgerald. Tom Barrasso there to play it. Comes around the dasher to center. Played there by Norton. Norton gets it in. It's Dennis for Thomas. Is cutting near side. Taglianetti. Parks. Parks centered, but he hit the side of the net. Crisp the shot. Just wide through a screen. Rick Tocchet breaking McEachern. And McEachern touching it, but it was a two-line pass. Pittsburgh clearly now is trying to get somebody back behind the Islander defense to start this third period. That time they had McEachern out and breaking.
You know, 1990 was the last year that the Pittsburgh Penguins missed the playoffs. That's the year before they won their first cup. It was also the last time the New York Islanders made the playoffs. You know, the guy that scored the biggest goal for the New York Islanders that year that they made the playoffs, the last time they made it, was the guy that just sat down, Uwe Krupp, but he wasn't wearing the New York Islanders uniform. He played for the Buffalo Sabres, and right here at the Igloo, the last game of the season, he scored an overtime goal that mathematically eliminated the Pittsburgh Penguins and put the New York Islanders into the playoffs. The Islanders had just finished a game against the Flyers, their last game of the season, and waited in their building in Long Island to see if they made it, and Uwe Krupp got him in.
Save made by Healy. He's coming up big again. Samuelson dumps it in. Healy again comes out of the net to play it. Tip it up along the boards. Thomas just dropped it off, and the Islanders, Kasparaitis, glides with Samuelson. Played back for Yager. Yager pinned up by King. Battles through it. Yager coming. Yager over Daniels. Saved by Healy. Jeff Daniels set up by Jaromir Yager for what would have been the tying goal. And again, it was Glenn Healy to knock it away. King sends it in. Thomas along the boards. He lost it. Played up by Daniels. Pittsburgh has definitely picked the pace up. Intercepted Larry Murphy. He's got a step on Norton. Back in the middle of Yager. Francis just trailing the play. Backhand shot deflected wide. Stevens couldn't control it behind the net. Islanders trying to get it out of the zone. Do as Jennings tried to bat it in. And he got knocked down from behind. And a penalty coming up on it. Delayed call against the Islanders. Extra skater up for Pittsburgh. Murphy shot deflected. Hit the post.
I think it was the skate kick, Gary, and I think the replay will show that Kevin Stevens kicked it up towards his stick, and which was also towards the net, and tried desperately to make contact with the puck before it crossed the line with his stick to make it legal.
He's not arguing very much about it.
No.
So he obviously feels the call was a right one. And a good view, Terry Gregson right there on the goal line where he was supposed to be. Play judge upstairs, of course. We'll take a look at it as we do.
You can see Healy out challenging again. Remember in the first period, he was tucked back in. There's Stevens with the skate. There he took his swat at it and missed it. Had he been able to make contact with the puck with his stick, it would have counted. Healy was out cutting down the angle. The skate, oh, man, he just missed it on the way in.
He was also in the crease ahead of the puck. Either way, I think that one doesn't count. Watch his skate right there.
Yeah, it's... I wonder if he would have called a skate.
I think so. I think he did. I think you're right, Bill. I think
the
it was
kick in the crease. The kick.
I think that's what it was. So Gregson making the call. Now in hockey, of course, the video replay judge looks at this anew. And if the video replay judge felt the official was wrong, the replay judge could call down and say, no, you're wrong. He wasn't kicked in or he wasn't in the crease and could count the goal. But that's not going to happen here because either way you look at it, it was right. And meanwhile, Thomas is going to go to the penalty box for cross-checking at 3:01. That was a delayed call. Pittsburgh had the extra skater out there.
And the official announcement said that the goal was disallowed because it was kicked into the net.
Now the Pittsburgh Penguins, who are 0-4 here on the power play, get a chance to tie it up as they go back to work on the power play. 7-4-31 on the power play. They had trouble against the Islanders during the regular season. They picked up only 3 power play goals and 32 chances against the Islanders during the regular season. The Islanders are coming right back out and doing it to them again. The Islanders have scored 2 shorthanded goals in this game to take the lead. Stevens drops it off. Brought in by Cockett, who runs it down the board. Played behind the net. Francis moved in to free the puck up. Islanders trying to get it clear, and they're going to right here. 2-on-2 the other way, sent by Mullen. Not far enough for the Islanders, though. Cockett was there to intercept. Francis brings it back in. Francis back to Murphy. Islanders up by a goal. Pittsburgh trying to get it tied. On the power play, Mullen, and he got it off the heel of the stick. Rebound came right to the side of the net and cleared.
A little too hard for Joey Mullen to handle. I mean, that was a bullet pass. Your timing has to be perfect.
Pittsburgh getting it back in a hurry. Cockett back to Francis. Down to Cockett. Stevens in front of the net. Mullen there with him. Islanders all alone on the near side. 45 seconds left on the power play chance. Murphy plays it at center after it had been run up through center ice by Tom Fitzgerald. Cockett dropping it off for McEachran. Sean McEachran. Kasparaitis get a piece. Yager. Yager waiting. Off to McEachran. McEachran. Yager. Along the boards, Kasparaitis and Yager. Taken away by Uwe Krupp. Good play by Krupp. Short-handed again. Benoit Hogue. Hogue moves it in 3-on-3. Fitzgerald cutting to the net. Couldn't get it back to him. Yager picks it up. 15 seconds left on the Pittsburgh advantage. Dave Tippett off to Yager. Yager, Tippett, and McEachran. Yager looking for the shot. Takes it. Healy makes the save. And it bounces high off the glass to Tippett. 4 on the power play for Pittsburgh. Running out of time on it. Shot. Healy kicked it out. Another good save. Rebound held in off Samuelson. Penalty's over. Thomas is back out on the ice. Drop down in front. Krupp is there. Krupp gets hauled down. And a penalty coming up for the Pittsburgh Penguins. Power play for the Islanders, who lead by 1.
Well, the Islanders Islanders have been patient. Now they get a chance to widen their margin. Uwe Krupp, number 4, is hooked down by Sean McKechnie, number 15 of the Penguins. So the Islanders are going in the power play. Glenn Healy has been strong. Watch him kick this rebound. He seems to have, Gary, such a great sense of when there's a rebound guy coming towards him and where to kick it by him. And sometimes that backfires. If you don't see a guy coming from a sharp angle, you can put it right on his stick. But the guys that really see well, and Healy's one of them, kick rebounds really into the appropriate spots all the time and push it right by the guys that are attacking them.
Scotty Bowman, Rick Keel, Rick Patterson, Barry Smith, the assistants who do so much work for him. His team down here in the opening game of the second round. Healy tried to get it, could not. Malakhov sends it back in for Norton. McKechnie out on that hooking call, and the power play chance here for the Islanders, already up by one, a chance to get it back to two. Thomas trying to send it in. Samuelson knocked it away to Francis. Francis coming. Francis with Joey Mullen. Mullen down at the blue line. Gets right back up. Healy was able to play it. Intercepted. Francis, they're trying shorthanded. Mullen couldn't get it on the forehand shot as King moved in and took it away. And it'll be the New York Islanders power play continuing with a minute 23 left on it. Charles Samuelson hit by King. Down he goes. Played by King to free the puck up and keep it alive. On the blue line, Norton. Norton getting some work along the blue line as the Islanders try and pick their power play unit up. Struggled against Washington. Shot Malakhov. Blocker save made by Barrasso. Kicked around. Ferraro giving chase. Samuelson cut him off, and it's cleared out of the zone by Mullen. 1 minute left to go in this power play for the Islanders. 13:46 left in the third period. The Islanders leading it 3-2. Shots are to Pittsburgh's advantage right now, but just by one, 26-25. Barrasso again helping out and cleared out of the zone one more time.
You know, in spite of the fact that the Islanders at times have forechecked well in this game, they haven't done a good job of keeping the puck away from Tom Barrasso. He has moved it up by 20, 25 times at least.
Amazing how many times he handles the puck for long distances. Offside are the Islanders with 31 seconds left on their power play. We'll check in with John Saunders. Thanks very much. Firepower in that game. And boy, was there some in the last series, Calgary and Los Angeles.
But the Kings can't play the way they played against Calgary and come out of that series against the Vancouver Canucks. I mean, it was run and gun, and we'll just hope for the best against the Calgary Flames. But the Canucks are a much more disciplined team and better on both sides of the puck.
Oh, what a chance, Benoit Hogue. Tom Barrasso knocked that away with a stick as Hogue had a great chance with a power play goal. He was coming in. The puck was right on the stick. Barrasso reached out and blocked it point blank range. 10 seconds left on the Islander power play. Dennis Vasky leaves it. Flatley. Flatley got tied up. Vasky's got to send it in. Way offside here. Pittsburgh will get a free out on this one, and the penalty's over. So they've killed it off. So both teams having trouble in the power play. 0 for 5 for Pittsburgh, 0 for 3 for the New York Islanders, who lead by 1. Islanders up here. Mario Lemieux played one shift at the start of this game.
And he went to the boards with number 4, Uwe Krupp. Now, Krupp is the guy that went down on this. When you have lower back problems, it doesn't take much. Maybe you torque your body, your legs get pushed one way, and your back the other way. You see Mario came off of Uwe Krupp a little difficultly. It doesn't take much, obviously. I mean, listen, anytime you've got a lower back problem, anybody that's ever had one will tell you, well, you can bend over to do up your shoes or your skates the way it happened to Mario the last year, a couple of years ago in the playoffs, and all of a sudden it's gone again. Doesn't take much.
Well, he's out of this game. That's all he played. And Yager at the far end went over for the touch-up, but he's got a panel of glass that's come out here. The fans hanging on to that one. Some of the guys were out skating, the players who aren't playing today, earlier this afternoon, and there were many sections of glass that were missing. They had to put all this back in today after Pittsburgh graduated yesterday here using the arena, so all the glass and the boards all came down. So sometimes when they get replaced, they're not all that solid. And while they do that, we'll take a break. We'll be back. John, thanks very much. Islanders leading 3-2 here, and it's Jaromír Jágr bringing it in. Jágr tied up by Kasparaitis. Jágr moves around him. Jágr, great strength for this 21-year-old. He takes a whack on the head from Kasparaitis. Still has the puck. Back to Murphy. His shot. Saved by Healy, who did not see that one coming through the screen. The Islanders back off here. They do not want any penalties. Brad Delgado and Stevens.
Play a skating finesse game as it is a blocking and jamming game. Look at the front of the net. Rick Tocchet tied up with Jeff Norton. The Pittsburgh Penguins are being forced to go back to that type of approach, Gary, because there's no skating room for them. They're not being left alone long enough to make any pretty plays, so you got to engage. Jump into the trenches in front the way Rick Tocchet did and hope for the best. He deflected that one right onto Healy. But the Islanders have definitely dictated the type of tempo and the style of play that they wanted in this hockey game.
Yep, there, Al Arbor's got to be very happy that his team has listened and done what he asked them to do here, no matter what the outcome. Obviously, they got the lead this late. 12:02 left to go in the third. They want to win, but they played well. Pittsburgh jamming in front. Came to the near side for Jagr, but went right by him. Samuelson holds it in. Jagr behind the net, looking for Stevens in front. Jagr's getting a ton of ice time with Mario Lemieux out of this game today. Out there with Tocchet and Stevens now. Jagr again. Jagr trying to wrap around. Krupp just will not let him in. Jagr gets there himself. Jagr looking. Drops it off for Al Samuelson. His shot. Healy makes the save. Jagr's putting on a show here in the third period.
Well, I'll tell you what, when he decides to get out of the corner, Gary, there's nobody better in the league. You think you got him tied up. He does a quick pivot, and away he goes. Absolutely leaves you in front of the net. Three Islanders actually went down to try to stop him. So watch him here. His balance is so good. Krupp is 6'6", 235, so he wasn't quick enough to get him. But look, Krupp diving, another one going down. Three Islanders right there, finally, to get the puck off of Jagr's stick.
34 goals and 60 assists for this 21-year-old Jaromir Jagr, who's a star in this city. Little Mario, the nickname, and he's playing a big Mario role right now in this game.
Boy, the European players are such huge players in this league now. Scotty Bowman coached the last hockey team that won a Stanley Cup without a European on its roster, the 1978-79 Montreal Canadiens, the last team to win the Cup without at least one European.
That was blocked in front. Nobody could get a handle on it as it's set. Ferraro brings it out. Ray Ferraro. Ferraro's got his ninth goal of the playoffs in this game. Shot and a save for Asso. Kicks it away near side. Malakhov will have to chase it down. These teams have played twice in playoff history. In 82 in the first round, the Islanders won it 3-2. Quarterfinals in 75, the Islanders won it 4-3. That was before Mario Lemieux turned into the superstar of the game. Francis drops it on. Right back out the Islanders, trying to play it safe flatly. Dumped it ahead. Ferraro's onside. Ferraro coming. Ferraro looking for a little help. Flatly joins it. Tipped through the middle by Benoit Hogue. In the corner, Patrick Flatly tied up by Taglianetti. Puck's free. Taglianetti. Hogue. Hogue and Taglianetti. Centered shot to save Barrasso. Rebound was tipped by Ferraro, but wide. Here comes McEachran. McEachran with Mullen. Chased into the corner, Kasparaitis. Kasparaitis got it around. They'll get it out of the zone. Benoit Hogue still out ahead for Ferraro. Islanders need a change. So Ferraro just feathers that one down the board. Thomas back with Jennings. Jennings touching it up. There's no icing on it. Grant Jennings. He'll lead the rush. The defenseman sends it in wide. They've done a lot of dumping and chasing here, and that's to the Islanders' benefit because the Islanders are getting to the puck first when it's dumped into the zone. Tom Barrasso's got to come out and play this with Steve Thomas moving up on it. He did. At center, Jennings couldn't get it away from Thomas. Thomas sends it right back in. Barrasso to the side of the net. Zone had not been cleared, and that will be an offside. Don't forget, next Saturday.
Boy, what a terrific year this rookie has had. He has really irritated every other team in the National Hockey League, but Darius Kasparaitis is a member of such a young defensive group here with the New York Islanders. Average age for the guys that have played for the Islanders in the playoffs, 24.4 years of age compared to the Penguins' average age, 30. The Islanders, four rookies since Scott Lachance is injured and out of the lineup, four rookies on their blue line. The Penguins, none. Coming into the playoffs, 65 games of experience on the blue line for New York Islanders, 400 to Pittsburgh.
Not a problem, you see. Cleared in by Jennings. Malakhov back to get it. Looks like just having a zero there. Jagr giving chase. Jennings will get there first. The Islanders have played this game. They've got the 3-2 lead. Plenty of time left for anything, though. 9:30 to go. Jagr again. Jagr got spun around as Kasparaitis got a piece. And again, the Islanders just clearing it out. Barrasso will let it go to pick up the icing call on the touch-up by Taglianetti, stopping the clock with 9:17 left here in the third.
You know, it really isn't a problem. You say not a problem. But when you win a playoff round, I think that's really when you leave your rookie year behind. And the New York Islanders have gone through that typical growth spurt that teams go through. When you win a playoff round, your rookies, your young guys, all of a sudden become veteran guys very quickly. I mean, look at the North Stars that went to the finals with an average team. And the New Jersey Devils in 1988 that went to the conference finals.
Experience so matters. We talk about that a lot in many sports. I'm not sure it ever matters quite as much as it does in Stanley Cup playoffs. Pittsburgh with a shot advantage of just one. It is different. It is not the regular season. The intensity is so much greater when you get into the playoffs. And if you haven't been there, it's kind of a shock when you step on the ice. I would expect
big time.
The way it looks anyway.
Big time. It's intense and the adrenaline flows. And really, it's the challenge that you've never faced in your life at this level of controlling your adrenaline, challenging it, channeling it into positive things, and avoiding making big mistakes. Basically, it's focusing and becoming the ultimate in pro athletics, and that is being able to compete at this level. But I'll tell you what, it's unnerving the first time you try it.
That's why getting through that first playoff series for a rookie matters, and Lyman getting upset here. Steven, boy, a big argument with Claude Loisel. He's already chased two out of there. Well, visiting team's going to put the stick down first on a faceoff. And the problem we're having is nobody wants to go down first here with the stick.
And Claude Loisel was arguing with Randy Mitten, and Chuckles Mitten's not going to give you any room to argue. He's just going to stand right in your face and tell you to get out.
Stevens and Delgado finally. Malakhov knocked out from behind. Centering pass by Samuelson was blocked. Good play in front of the net again by Claude Loisel. Two on one. Green and Loisel. Claude Loisel! And he missed it. Shot it over the head of Tom Barrasso. Rebound near side corner. Centered again. Green. Travis Green. Shot! Barrasso knocks it away with Loisel on the doorstep. Picked up. Not out. Stevens trying to clear the zone. Does. Islanders a great chance right there. Pittsburgh trying to get this game tied with 8:48 to go. They are down a goal. Straight up on the far side to Loisel again. Loisel to Travis Green. Islanders changing it up. Jager battling down. He goes. Loisel back to get it. Just sweeps it in or tries. It ends up on the Pittsburgh bench. Running out of time. The Islanders up.
Boy, a rare two-on-one in this hockey game. This time for the New York Islanders, Travis Green. Perfect feed to Claude Loisel, but look how much time it takes him to look, to tee it up. He glided about 12 feet, and that's how much time Tom Barrasso needed to get over. And at 6'3", 212 with all the gear, it's a big obstacle to overcome. Claude Loisel, as we mentioned, defensive specialist, 5 goals during the regular season, and he hasn't scored here in the playoffs. Perhaps the sniper would have just redirected that one much quicker, but Claude Loisel hung onto it, and Barrasso got back.
And it remains a 3-2 Islander lead now. The even strength with 8:20 left to go. Shots are 28-28. Patrick Flatley in. Puck checked away. Murphy. Great play. Larry Murphy reaching in. Not out of the zone. The Islanders holding behind the net. Benoit Hogue. Hogue centered. Flatley trying to get it across ice. Couldn't. The Islanders, though, creating the opportunities. Hogue again tied up by Grant Jennings. Puck free. Patrick Flatley came back to get it. Has Ferraro in front of the net. They're looking to set it up to Ferraro. Ferraro tied up by Francis. Ferraro digging. Francis pins him up against the boards. Puck still free there. Larry Murphy comes away with it. 7:50 left to go here in the third period. Up ice intended for Jeff Daniels. Blocked by Hogue. Sent in by Mullen. Back to get it. Glenn Healy left it behind the net. Healy lifetime 4-8-2 in his career. Regular season games against the Pittsburgh Penguins. Tom Barrasso 16-9-2 against the New York Islanders. And Barrasso right now looking at a one-goal deficit, knows with 7:26 to go, he can't afford to let another one go in here and let that lead go back to two. Islanders just got hit in the face with a puck. Cleared at center. Derek King took that one. King stays on the ice. King had the puck just bounce up and hit him right in the face. He's still out there. Tippett the other way. Tippett with Samuelson looking to the front of the net. Deflected in the air. Down it goes. Needham was cutting to the net and got hauled down as he rushed the middle. Played by Derek King the other way. Derek King over the blue line. Islanders are offside as Shel Samuelson had created it. Thomas got hauled into the zone.
Right, Gary, the Islanders have not gone into a defensive shell. They've been able to move the puck out of their zone. The Penguins aren't putting much pressure on them. And check these numbers, the odd man advantages. These are key, especially for the New York Islanders. The Islanders have had one breakaway in this game. That was the Ferraro goal. Pittsburgh, none. Two on ones. The Islanders have had one. The Penguins have had none. Three on twos that are nearly as dangerous as two on ones or breakaways. The Penguins have an advantage, but Al Arbour has gotten the only breakaway in this game and the only two on one. That was the scoring chance we just saw with Claude Loisel in the pass from Travis Green. If you can play the Penguins and eliminate breakaways, two on ones, and do a pretty good job in the three-on-twos. Got a good chance, boy.
And score two shorthanded goals while holding Pittsburgh goal for five on the power play. Knocked away Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald would play at the blue line to free it up. He gets knocked down by Shel Samuelson. Barrasso, Alf Samuelson has it. His pass up the boards comes to Tippett. Tippett out there with Sean McEachran on the far side wing. McEachran moved over. Just batted up in the air that time. finally sent in by McEachran, and he'll head to the bench, and Pittsburgh will change it up. They'll get Stevens and Yager back out there again, looking for the scoring power they need with 6:25 left to go in this game. Just been told Rich Pilon's injured a knee. He's going to be evaluated after the game. Joey Mullen has left the game for the Pittsburgh Penguins. He went over into the locker room a minute ago. Mario Lemieux is injured on the first shift. This is the first game of just the second round. Green's pass intercepted. Yager trying to bring it in. Got nailed along the blue line. Islanders not giving him any room. Sent in again by Mullen to the near side. Brian Mullen getting that one in. Taglianetti around the boards to Tockett. Tockett looking. Stevens and Yager out with him. Stevens couldn't handle it. Baskey right back up and out of the zone. Boy, they're wearing Pittsburgh down here.
Hey, Gary, they're still sending two men in deep on the forecheck. You really go into a fallback position if you say, okay, one man in, everybody else back. A 1-2-2 or a 1-4 type of forecheck. Look at this. The Islanders all in deep. Here they are.
Shot Green and a save made by Barrasso. Travis Green. Norton trying to hold it in behind the net. Barrasso just held it there. Barrasso had to hold the fort on that one. Green was all alone in front of the net for Yager. Couldn't get it. Krupp moved in on him. Good play away. Krupp again. Cleared back out the center. Jennings back to get it. 5:13 remaining. Game one. Best of seven. Second round. This is for the Patrick Division Championship. The Islanders and the Pittsburgh Penguins. Penguins defending two consecutive cups, but down here 3-2. Shot by Daniels. Save made by Healy. Jeff Daniels. Good quick shot along the ice. Glenn Healy knocked it away. Back to get it. Again, Jennings. Grant Jennings off the boards. Islanders all over the place at center ice. No room. Poop to the red line. Jennings right back in. McEachran giving chase with Norton. Norton there. They collide as they go to the boards. Islanders Benoit Hogue knocked away by Francis. Put back behind the net. Krupp going back to get it. Louis Krupp. He'll head man it up himself. Stick right out of the hands of Sean McEachran as he went by. Krupp dumps it. They change up again. 4:24 left in the third. Thomas the hit. Murphy, though, picks up the loose puck. McEachran will bring it. McEachran's working out there now with Daniels. Love down by Healy. Again, the change. Pittsburgh on the fly. Francis came in, put the hit on. Parks was there to get the puck in front of the net. Larry Murphy with Parks on him. Back for Samuelson. Tipped away. Parks has it. Good play by King to free that puck up. Tom Barrasso again pushing it away from Thomas. Pittsburgh fans with the Let's Go Pens chant trying to get it going. Mike Needham has got a goal. Moves in, but that's going to be an offside two-line pass. Tom Barrasso, 4-1 in the playoffs. Glenn Healy, 4-1 in the playoffs. And right now the Islanders have the 3-2 lead here in this game. Mullen giving chase. Taken away by Kasparaitis. Murphy trying to hold it in, does. Murphy just sends it into the far side corner. 3:37 left to go. Pittsburgh now, everybody joins the offensive flow. Islanders will try and take advantage of that by springing somebody on one of those odd man breaks. Murphy brings it up. Murphy drops it off. Mullen, take it away from him. Nice play, Travis Green. Green stepped in and chucked that one away. Knocked away at center ice. Troy Loney back for Martin Straka. Norton intercepts the other way. It's a little furious now. Sent in by Steve Thomas off the glass. Pittsburgh Penguins lost one game in the playoffs against the New Jersey Devils in the first round. They had come into this season having gone with 11 straight wins to wrap up the Stanley Cup championship last year in the playoffs. And the Islanders are challenging them in the first game of this series. Tockett set it to the near side. Tockett, Stevens, Yager. We'll get a lot of ice time here in the final 2 minutes, 46 seconds. Back for Stevens. Stevens pinned up by Dennis Baskin. Yager moves in again. Pucks underneath against the boards long enough for Gregson to whistle it. We'll have a faceoff with 2:36 left. Coming up next on it. Waiting right now for their pens.
Travis Green had all he could do to handle Jaromir Jagr. Now, when Al Arbor, who wasn't going to match line in this hockey game, unless it was convenient, has a chance now, he's going to end up with Travis Green, Brad Delgarno, perhaps Brian Mullen out there against whatever the top unit is at the time for the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Travis Green is out there right now. 2 minutes, 36 seconds remaining. Green on the faceoff against Francis. Played around the net by Baskey. Not out. Shot by Samuelson. Deflected out deep off Baskey's skate. Held in by Samuelson again. Green has it, and Green clears it out. Shots are 30-29 in favor of Pittsburgh, but it's the Islanders leading 3-2. 2:18 left to go here in the third. Samuelson ahead, knocked down. Ryan Mullen got it back the other way. Joel Samuelson cleared it up to the line. Francis knocked it away. Pittsburgh trying to rush the puck. Green right there to knock it away again. And it'll be Mullen just flipping it into the wide side corner. Joel Samuelson and Ulf Samuelson, the defensive pairing. Want to welcome Yildizou, who have been watching Vancouver and Los Angeles. Gary Thorne, Bill Clement here in Pittsburgh, and the Islanders a minute 50 away from an upset in game one. They lead this by a score of 3-2, had led by a 3-2 lead. Flatley in the middle, couldn't get it. Shel Samuelson clears it out. The Pittsburgh Penguins at home for this opener of the second round. Got on the board first in the first period, but then Malakhov, Ferraro, and Hogue had three unanswered goals before Daniels made it a one-goal game for Pittsburgh. Fitzgerald breaks it up. Fitzgerald in, the shot and a save made by Barrasso. Rebound flipped away. Benoit Hogue is there. Hogue dropped it off for Mullen. A minute 19 to go. We'll keep an eye on Tom Barrasso at the other end. Jennings will send it in. Islanders 3, Pittsburgh 2. A minute 11 left to go in regulation play. Barrasso still in net. 2-on-2 the other way. Fitzgerald again with Flatley. Shot saved by Barrasso. And he hangs on with Flatley cruising in. Tom Fitzgerald has played himself a strong game. A couple of assists and two good rushes here on this last shift.
And Malakhov moved it up ice. And the Islanders had a real slick breakout. Tom Fitzgerald was able to move down for this shot on Tom Barrasso. But believe me, it started in the defensive zone. The Islanders have shown absolutely no panic back there.
The well-disciplined game that the New York Islanders, Al Iverson, they had to play, they have gotten. You see, the Pittsburgh Penguins have not lost a playoff game at home since May 7 of 92 against the Rangers. They have won their last 9 in playoff style here at home. The Islanders are threatening to take that home ice advantage away here in game one with just a minute 2 left. And Pittsburgh is using their 30-second timeout right.
Standing there, they're not working on any plays. They're going to rely on the skill level, I guess, of their top forwards to make something happen creatively once they get into the offensive zone. So it's take a little rest and let your talent take over.
Those of you joining us late, we remind you that Pittsburgh has played this game without Mario Lemieux except for the first shift of the game. Lemieux has had back spasm problems today. So the battle begins of survival in the Stanley Cup playoffs.
Right.
Literally.
Now the Islanders, when they do dump it into the zone, if they get it out of their end, they're in the offensive zone now, but this isn't going to last forever. When they bring it up, they're going to have to keep it away from Tom Barrasso. He is still going to be a key in this.
1 minute left to go in the third period. The Islanders looking to upset the Pittsburgh Penguins in game one. Behind the net. Barrasso, of course, will be moving up if they can get it out. The way Krug wouldn't let it. Goes by Yager. Barrasso's got to go back in net. Francis sends it through the middle. Fireside Mullen. Mullen giving chase, no icing. Barrasso up. Kasparaitis got it out of the zone. Pittsburgh gets the extra skater. Tockett comes out of the ice. Barrasso's on the bench. Krug knocked it down. Krug got it in the jersey. Got it away long enough for Mullen to play it up off the boards. You're looking at the time remaining here in regulation. Jaromír Jágr. Jágr in the middle. Mullen. Mullen diving for it. Good play by Mullen to keep it alive, but offside are the Pittsburgh Penguins with 19.8 remaining in the third.
Just playing hard, sending people in, and having to dig like crazy and replaying defensively to get back in time.
Boy, have the Islanders done that in this game. The Islanders lost the regular season series to Pittsburgh 4-3, but they won 2 games here at the Igloo. Pittsburgh won 2 and lost 1 in Long Island. 14 seconds left to go. Flipped in. Glenn Healy looking for the victory in net. Kasparaitis back. Took the hit from Stevens. That held the puck in. Stevens tipped it. Just missed. Jágr cutting through. They've got one more chance. In front of the net. Jágr turns around. Can't get it in the corner. Tipped on the goal, and that's it. The New York Islanders have upset the Pittsburgh Penguins in game one of the second round. The full house leaving here in Pittsburgh, Bill Clement, silenced by a 3-2 victory of the Islanders.
They were pretty quiet all afternoon, Gary, simply because the Islanders didn't allow the Penguins that big flow, that big skill finesse game that really gets this crowd into it. And I think, to a degree, they were silenced when Mario Lemieux left this hockey game. They may be in shock.
Glenn Healy gets the victory in net for the New York Islanders. Tom Barrasso takes the loss. Our coverage of the Stanley Cup playoffs on ABC. Islanders 3, Pittsburgh 2.